Songs you can sing along with every day, 24/7. How you doing? Shannon on the radio, Super Saturday. This is the True Oldies Channel.
Run, 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 little run, run. When I wanted you to share my life, I had no doubt in my mind that it's been you, woman, right down the line. I know how much I lean on you, only you can see the changes that I've been through. How bad the mark on me. You've been as constant as another star, the brightest light that shines. It's been you, woman, right down the line. I just wanna say this is my way of telling you everything I can ever say before. Yeah, this is my way of telling you that every day I'm loving you so much, love. Cause you believe in me through my darkest night. There's something better inside of me. You brought me into light. Threw away those crazy dreams, I put them all behind. And it was you, woman, right down the line. Just more say this is my way of telling you everything I can ever say before. Yeah, this is my way of telling you that every day I'm loving you so much, love. If I should doubt myself, if I'm losing ground, I won't turn to someone else. They don't let me down. When I wanted you to share my life, I had no doubt in my mind that it's been you, woman, right down the line.
You got the True Oldies Channel with Shannon playing the greatest hits right here in the Mothership Studios. Jerry Rafferty in there right down the line. Well, if you're bored today and you want to check out some funny things, check out...
Yeah. This is the Shore Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 3 minutes. Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 2 minutes. Shore Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 1 minute. This is the Shore Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 30 seconds. This is the Shore Sports Network from SFMSports.net. Our broadcast begins in 10 seconds.
Eastern Shore and SFMSports.net welcomes you to this presentation of Hawks basketball. Now, Maryland Eastern Shore basketball from SFMSports.net.
At the William P. Hytche Athletic Center in Princeton, Maryland, it's time for Maryland Eastern Shore men's basketball. Tonight, the Hawks take on the Lancers of Longwood University, and we've got all the action for you on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net. Hello, everybody. Will DeBoer with you, courtside. Alongside me, Dave Bird, the Dean of Pocomoke City High Athletics. And Dave, glad you're healthy enough to join us, although I can smell the cherry lozenge on your breath over there.
I hope you like cherry. I can tell you that.
Yeah.
That'll help me out throughout the course of the night. And when I speak, I'll try to speak fluently and short. How about that?
Short, sweet, and to the point. That's why we like you.
You got that.
Absolutely. Hawks trying to get into the wins column this season. Maryland Eastern Shore 0-2, coming off of two tough games against major conference opponents. Saturday, they went down to North Carolina State, and they lost to the Wolfpack 95-49. It was out of hand by halftime, 51-15 at the break. Eastern Shore played them tougher in the second half, only losing that period 44-34. A.J. Cheeseman led the Hawks with 18 points and 7 rebounds. He played 33 minutes of action, despite being in foul trouble, and he only fouled out of the game with 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the second half. Ryan Andino poured in 14 points to spark, despite another shaky shooting effort from long range. And Brian Rudia stuffed the stat sheet, 8 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists, and 4 steals. So Dave, through the first two games, seemed to be a triumvirate forming of the backcourt in Rudia, the front court in Cheeseman, and the wing player and shooter in Andino.
Yeah, and that's where you need them. But we need them at the guard position to step up. And we're going to find out tonight. They got a couple good guards at Longwood, so it's going to be a nice matchup, guard versus guard.
Indeed it will be. And the Longwood Lancers, this isn't your father's Longwood Lancers team. Long as they have been the laughingstock of Division I, or at least one of them. They're going for their first winning season since 2008 and 2009, and they're looking for their first 3-0 start since joining the ranks of Division I back in 2004 and 2005. Last year, they went 7-26, last place in the Big South, 15 in conference, but this is a brand new team. They beat the Richmond Spiders of the A-10, 63-58, back on Friday. And the Lancers, under new management, might sound familiar to you, Griff Aldridge. It's his first head coaching job. You may recognize him from the UMBC teams of the last two seasons. Yes, the same UMBC that beat Virginia, the number one seed in the NCAA tournament last year, the 16-1 upset. Griff Aldridge was essentially the chief of staff for Ryan Odom that season, and he brings his personal brand and his coaching expertise to the Longwood Lancers.
Right, and UMBC, the talk of the state of Maryland, actually the talk of college basketball last year, and we're privileged to see them a couple times during the course of the last couple of years, and hopefully, I'm sure Longwood is hoping that some of that UMBC can rum off on them.
Indeed, the Hawks will try and put down that UMBC magic. In fact, 2 years ago this very day, UMBC was in town. It was the second game of the Ryan Odom Griff Aldridge era for the Retrievers. They came in and beat the then Bobby Collins led Hawks 77-73. Coach Aldridge and the Lancers looking for a repeat of that feat, and the Hawks trying to win their first home game of the regular season and get into the wins column for the first time in 2018-19, the first time in the Cliff Reed era. On the other side of this commercial break, we'll speak with Cliff Reed, interim head coach of Hawk men's basketball, talk about this game, the matchup, and matching up against Griff Aldridge once again. And we'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip-off at approximately 7 o'clock sharp. We're glad you could join us on your Tuesday night, everybody. This is the Shore pregame show on the Shore Sports Network and SFM Sports.
The Eastern Shore is a perfect place to visit year-round. A gem hidden on the lower shore is the Henson. Located in the heart of Princess Anne on the picturesque campus of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, the Henson is the perfect choice for campus visits, business trips, reunions, meetings, and relaxing getaways. Check into the Henson and we'll take care of the rest. Book online at umes.edu/Henson.
Hey Hawks fans, season tickets are on sale now. Visit umestickets.com to get your basketball season tickets. Stop by the athletic office, go online, or check your mailbox. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore tickets. There's no better place to be this basketball season than the Hytche. Cheering your Hawks on towards the conference championship. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore basketball season tickets now at umestickets.com. Support Eastern Shore Athletics, because after all, this is our shore and our team.
Hawks fans, for over a century, Delmarva Power has provided safe, reliable energy to customers throughout here at the shore to throughout Maryland and Delaware. To learn more, visit delmarva.com or call 1-800-375-7117. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFMSports.net.
We're back on the Shore pregame show. Cliff Reed's here, head coach of Hawk men's basketball. We're a few minutes away from taking on Longwood University. So, Coach, here we are, third game of the year. Your general thoughts coming into this one?
Good evening, Will. First of all, things are moving quick. First of all, we were back in August getting ready to go on a foreign trip. Now we're into the season. We're in November into the season, third game. We have a different type of an opponent. They just come off a very big win versus an A-10 school in Richmond. They play extremely well. They're athletic. They really guard you. They're tough. They shoot the ball well. So we have our hands more than full with Longwood this afternoon.
And thinking about that, at least on paper, you know, it's two teams, you know, mid-major levels. One's Big South, one is the MEAC, and this after, and we're coming off games against Big East and ACC schools. But like you said, it's a team that's trending up. They've won their first two. So what was the approach in practice coming into this one with that duality?
The approach is always the same. We try to get better. We work on fundamentals. We work on defense. We work on the things that it takes to create the culture and create having a success in a program. So we can constantly work on the same thing. But when you get closer to a game, you game plan based on that individual opponent a little bit more than you do when you're in non-season practice. So we worked on some things that we want to be able to do against them, and certain players that they have. Like I said, we game plan schemed, and that's the only difference. But we constantly work on being better at the things that help us no matter what the opponent is.
A couple days ago, went to North Carolina State, sort of got blitzed in the first half, but recovered and stuck with them for the most part for the second half. What were some silver linings that you took from that game down at Raleigh?
Just the second half, I thought that they would do what they did. They came out and Mike Tyson us, and that means overwhelmed us early. And I was hoping that we could withstand that early run and usually have to be able to not turn the ball over and make shots. And we had a few turnovers, and we didn't make shots. But the second half, we got our feet under us and started playing inside out, taking better shots, took better care of the basketball. And even though he was rotating 10 guys, five and five at a time, to try to make sure he kept up the level of intensity and level of play, we still were able to dig in and really play and execute and defend better.
We got Longwood coming in under a brand new head coach in Griff Aldridge, but one who's at least familiar with Maryland Eastern Shore. 2 years ago, in fact, tonight, he was the top assistant at UMBC from that 2016-17 season. What do you find happens when a former assistant from a team that you've played recently takes over and becomes the boss at another program, if that has happened to you?
It has, and, you know, there's familiarity, and he has some familiarity playing in this arena and being in this environment. I'm different, and the thought process is different. I know he's watched tape on us, and so we're doing a lot of different things than what we did a couple years ago. But so there's that familiarity he has, and he understands how to prepare. He understands the arena and the entire environment. So they'll be well prepared. I watched them on tape over and over the two games that they've had, and they're doing a really good job of defending. And they have guys who can make plays and shoot the ball.
Here we are back in the Hytche Center. It's the first home game of the regular season, 1-4 in the non-conference. I'm sure it's really important to come out and get this crowd involved in the first few minutes and this first chance for them to see them in their own building since March.
Absolutely. We hope to open up and really play hard and be aggressive and play with a lot of energy and give great effort, but also play smart early on. And hopefully that'll carry us throughout the game as we settle down and start to play.
I appreciate it, Coach. Best of luck out there.
Thank you, Will.
He's Cliff Reed, and his Hawks are getting ready to take on the Lancers. We'll be right back with the starting lineup from the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
If you think you could never afford a health plan, think again. 9 out of 10 people who enrolled through Maryland Health Connection last year got savings. And this year, rates are lower across most plans. They even have experts all across Maryland who can give you free in-person help to make sure you get the most savings. Learn more at MarylandHealthConnection.gov. That's MarylandHealthConnection.gov. Enrollment runs November 1st to December 15th, so don't wait. Explore your options today.
Liberty Mutual Insurance knows you're focusing on the road right now, so we'll just describe our new billboards to you. They're horizontal rectangles with a yellow background. The headline reads, Liberty Mutual customizes your auto insurance so you only pay for what you need. And while that might sound like a lot of words for a billboard, they all fit perfectly. Overall, it's a pretty great advertisement.
Go to libertymutual.com for a customized quote and you could save.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Coverage is underwritten by Liberty Mutual Insurance Company and affiliates, Equal Housing Insurer.
This is only the beginning. The moment you choose Maryland as the home of your sporting event, you're turning a key that will unlock the vast statewide resources and a regional support team second to none in the nation. Say the word, and Maryland Sports, the sports commission for the state of Maryland, is ready to work 24/7, 365 days a year to make your event a success. This is only the beginning, but in the end, we promise you a world-class event in a world-class destination.
For more details, visit marylandsports.us.
Do you ever wonder how we're streaming millions of movies on demand or turning homes into hotels? And how are we watching a live mission from Mars? Smart business minds dreamed these ideas, and Amazon Web Services is how they built them. With the broadest functionality and the most experience, the leading enterprises trust the AWS cloud to build the next big idea. Are you ready to build it? Learn more at awsishow.com.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from sfmsports.net.
We're back on the shore. The Eastern Shore Hawks and the Longwood Lancers getting ready for tip-off around 7 o'clock. Still about 4, 5, 6 minutes away from that, which gives us time to bring you tonight's starting lineups. First for Cliff Reed and the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks. Shaking things up a little bit with his starting lineup in game number 3. Kanan Bartley gets his first start as a Hawk. The 6'1 sophomore guard from Miami, Florida, by way of St. Petersburg College. Averaged 22 minutes a game over the first two games. 1 point and 3 rebounds. Ahmad Frost getting his first start of the year. 6-foot redshirt junior guard from Cincinnati, Ohio. Hasn't scored yet this year. Has 2 assists per game, 1.5 rebounds per game in 9.5 minutes. A.J. Cheeseman, 6'7 junior forward from Snellville, Georgia. Transfer from Gordon State College. 18.5 points, 4 rebounds per game. He ranks 3rd in the MEAC in points per game at this early juncture. Ryan Yerudia, 6'1 junior guard from El Paso, Texas, by way of Cochise College in Arizona. 10.5 points, 5.5 rebounds, 5.5 assists, and 4.5 steals, which ranks 3rd in the MEAC at this point. And Gabriel Jimfey, 6'6 junior guard from Brampton, Ontario. That's in Canada. Transferring from Colby Community College in Kansas. 4.5 points, 4 rebounds per game in 19 minutes off the bench per contest. So Bartley, Frost, Cheeseman, Arudia, and Jimfey. Only Cheeseman and Arudia are maintaining their starting roles. It's Ryan Andino, Tyler Jones, and Dante Caldwell all coming off the bench.
Yeah. And I think Coach Reed is shaking it up to get some different athleticism on the floor. A couple younger players probably put out in practice and doing well in practice, and maybe they get a chance to start. And that means we got some punch off the bench, though.
Yep, some punch off the bench. How much punch to be determined, and more on that on the other side of this break. But first, the Longwood Lancers, their starting lineup. Griff Aldridge, 9th head coach in Longwood history. His first season, the former chief of staff at history-making UNBC Retrievers. Isaiah Walton leads the way, 6'5 redshirt senior guard from Oberlin, Ohio. 21.5 points per game. That's 4th in the Big South. 8.5 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 steals for his first 2 contests. Had a triple-double in the win against Richmond, but not the good kind of triple-double. 23 points, 12 rebounds, 10 turnovers. Not exactly the third category that you want. Lorenzo Phillips, 6'1 junior guard from Houston, Texas. 11.5 points, 2 rebounds, 3.5 assists per game. Nicknamed Shabooty. Shabooty Phillips. That'll be fun to say.
Yes.
We got Pernell Adji, 6'8 redshirt junior forward from Dumfries, Virginia. 1.5 points, 4.5 rebounds per game, 10.5 minutes per contest. This is his 3rd start out of 3. Jordan Cintron, 6'8 sophomore forward from the Bronx, New York City. 9 points, 8.5 rebounds, and 2 steals per game for him. And Jayshawn Smith, 6'5", junior forward from Raleigh, North Carolina. Hey, we were just there. 8.5 points, 2.5 rebounds, 1.5 steals per game. He had 12 points in the win over Richmond on Friday. So Walton, Phillips, Adji, Cintron, and Smith for the Lancers. Bartley, Frost, Cheeseman, Arudia, and Jim. The Hawks in this matchup of 2 teams from the Mid-Atlantic. It's the fifth all-time meeting between the Hawks and the Lancers. Longwood has won the previous four. Last time they played, February 4th, 2009, the then Frankie Allen-led Hawks dropped a 98-86 decision at Longwood. It was their team's second matchup of the season. They played a rare home-and-home within one basketball season. Back on November 22nd of that year, 2008, the Lancers dealt Eastern Shore a 61-49 home loss. The Hawks trying to avenge that loss from 9 years ago now as we get ready for this matchup in 2018. We'll take one last break. When we come back, we promise the opening tip-off. The Hawks, the Lancers, coming up next on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again...
Stop at your local Eastern Shore McDonald's and enjoy a new 100% fresh beef quarter pounder sandwich. The recipe is simple. Fresh beef, hot and juicy, and made just for you. Try it on a signature crafted sandwich like the Pico Guacamole. Prices and participation may vary. Visit your Eastern Shore McDonald's.
I used to have more hair. I used to have more color. And I used to have cancer. I beat it. I did. Not alone. I used to have no idea what the American Cancer Society did. Research, yeah, but also free rides to chemo and free lodging in their hospitals. I used to maybe give a little, and I got so much back. I used to have cancer.
Please give at cancer.org.
The IRS finally caught up with Louie.
I hadn't paid my taxes in 8 years. I owed the IRS a lot of money.
Louie was in deep trouble.
We're going to take your house, put a lien on your bank account, garnish your pay. They don't care. They're going to take your paycheck.
Louie found out about Optima Tax Relief, the leading tax resolution firm. A-plus rated by the Better Business Bureau, they've resolved over $500 million for their clients.
Optima Tax, they help me. They calm me down. They made me feel comfortable, and I trust them.
Louie has a lot to be thankful for.
I don't owe the IRS anymore, and I'm able to live a comfortable life, a better life. It was because of Optima Tax.
For tax help you can trust, call Optima now for a free consultation. Take it from Louie.
If you owe the IRS, don't go it alone. Give Optima Tax a call. They can help you.
Call 800-343-6460. 800-343-6460. 800-343-6460.
Optima Tax Relief.
Testimonial from an actual client. Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Start your day with the new triple breakfast stacks. Bacon, sausage, egg, and cheese all piled high on your choice of biscuit, McMuffin, or McGriddle. Make it complete with a dollar any size hot coffee for just a buck for a limited time. Prices and participation may vary. Visit your local Eastern Shore McDonald's.
The flagship station for Maryland Eastern Shore basketball is WTGM Salisbury. Delmarva's Fox Sports 960.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Back at the Hytche Center, opening tip-off imminent. The Hawks and the Longwood Lancers, the first of four non-conference home games the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks will play this season. They're back at home Saturday, November 24th. That's a Saturday of Thanksgiving weekend against Central Penn. That's a 4 o'clock tip time. They got a Friday night, November 30th matchup against Delaware, 7 o'clock tip. And New Year's Eve, December 31st to Monday, 1 o'clock p.m. They're introducing the starting lineups right now, and Dave, we touched on this during the introductions, that the Hawks might not have that much firepower coming off the bench. Only eight Hawks are dressing right now, at least by my count here, and the three former starters who are on the bench tonight are Ryan Andino, Dante Caldwell, and Tyler Jones. They're the only ones on the bench tonight.
I know, I was trying to count. We're doing warm-up. I came up with nine, but I must have missed one.
Yes, the Hawks.
That's a slim bench.
It's a really slim bench. The Hawks only had 14 on their roster to begin with. Marlon Adams out for the season, of course, with the shoulder injury. But no Derek Green, no Colin Gaynor, no Montrez Oliver. Justice Bartley and Isaac Taylor, of course, are still nursing injuries as well. But eight players, this is highly reminiscent of what we saw for last year's Hawks team. A really thin bench, and it hurt them, I think, in the MEAC schedule. So whether or not this is just a one-game thing or something long-term is something to keep an eye on. In any case, deep bench and fouls might come into play tonight.
Yeah. Unless the Hawks are awful lucky, it's going to come into play. Yeah. this is all for early in the season, just be going with eight players.
Indeed, and now that we're complaining about seeing them in suits, you know, they are really good coats and ties. They're a slick-looking group of young men, but you'd rather see them in basketball get-ups.
Yeah, obviously, they look pretty good in shirt and tie, like you say, but we want them in that white basketball uniform of the Hawks.
Indeed we do, but the starting five for the Hawks taking the floor right now. They'll probably see quite a bit of minutes tonight. Bartley, Frost, Cheeseman, Arudia, and Jimphy. Eastern Shore taking the floor in their home white uniforms with the maroon trim. Their first time wearing these jerseys this season. They'll move left to right as we see them in this first half. The Longwood Lancers still huddled up, still talking things over. We've given them the horn. Time to come out and joust, fellas. The Lancers, after all.
Let's start. We're ready to bounce the ball here at the Hytche Center.
Quick question. Does Pocomoke City High have a jousting program?
No.
No?
We're kind of small, Will. We do a lot of stuff, but big schools.
I think you're close enough to Shinkatig. You might be able to take some of the ponies and use them as a jousting
it's a
animals.
That's a possibility. But the weather's been so bad, we wouldn't even be able to get outside.
It's game time. Pernell Adjei from Longwood, a tip against Gabriel Jimphy of the Hawks. Jimphy's shown himself adept at leaping it so far this season. Falls in the air, controlled by Adjei and Longwood, and we are underway from the shore. Lorenzo Phillips, right to left across the timeline for Longwood in the dark navy blue uniforms with the white trim. Walton attacks on the left baseline, lays it up, and in, and one. Isaiah Walton attacking the rack early. And Kanan Bartley bops him on the side of the head. And I'll put Walton on the line for a chance for a three-point play.
Yeah, he's going to be a tough matchup for a Hawk. 6'5 and long. Got some long arms, can jump, and he can put the ball in a basket from anywhere. So he's going to be a tough matchup for the Hawks tonight.
Free throw from Walton, a little bit strong off the back iron, and he's a 77% free throw shooter, but misses his first. 2-0 Longwood. At the drop of a bucket, we've just begun this game. Hawk basketball, here's A.J. Cheeseman on the right channel. Hands off back to Brian Arudia. Arudia, the floor general, the extension of Coach Reed on the floor. Top of the circle he is. Flicks it to Frost at the right wing. Thought about the three. Walton marked him pretty quickly. 9 to shoot. Skip to Jimphy at the top of the circle. Jimphy skips it out to Arudia on the left sideline. 4, 3 to shoot. Arudia driving in. Stop and pop at the free throw line. Back iron. Elevating for the board, Cintron. And here come the Lancers. This is Lorenzo Phillips. Laterals it back to Cintron. Tron kicks it into the right corner for Smith. Round the horn to the left corner for Walton. Walton back at the Cintron. Now on the right wing, it's Smith for three. Back iron. Rebound bounces once, controlled by Frost. Here come the Hawks left to right. Arudia into the front court. Zigzagging to Frost. Left wing for three. Short. Rebound tipped once, controlled by Pernell Adjei and the Lancers. This is Phillips across the big maroon M. Into the front court. Cintron. The Smith of the right wing, same play they ran coming into the front court, their last possession, and now he got a foul away from the basketball. Yeah. Somebody in blue took a tumble.
Way far away from the basket. And both teams playing man-to-man defense, opening up the game. Yeah, out of bounds now for Longwood underneath their own basket.
Clock resets to 20. Doesn't go to 30 as Bartley deflects, nearly gets the steal on the inbound, but Walton circles into the right elbow. Shot rattles off the iron. Bartley's there for the board. Here come the Hawks. Here's Arudia straight away, slowing things down. The Hawks set up. Frost on the right wing, nearly pickpocketed by Walton. Now kicks it to Jimphy left of center. Hand out to Arudia, juggles to himself. The Cheeseman straight away, skipped down low, and it's kicked by Adjei. Cheeseman tried to thread it through the eye of the needle towards Frost from the right baseline.
Yeah, Frost going back door on that baseline, and kick ball for Lancers. Hawk has the ball underneath their own basket.
2-0 Longwood, 18-22 remaining in the first half, so we're just a minute and a half in. Frost straight away for three. Got it. Ahmad Frost from downtown. That's his sweet spot. And the Hawks take the lead 3-2, 2 minutes into the ball game.
Yeah, that's great for the Hawks. If somebody can make some outside shots, that's going to be a big plus.
Longwood basketball. Here's Walton on the left wing, and he's got a handful of Bartley, and Bartley pushes him. A little too much body contact that time, and for Kanan Bartley, that's an early foul, and it's his second foul, and now we'll see a couple of substitutions. Ryan Andino's in for the Hawks off the bench. averaging 10 points per the first two games. And for Longwood, Sean Flood, junior guard, 6'2", from, of all places, Dublin, Ireland. They play basketball there. Straight away at Cintron. Fires from three. Misses strong. Arudia elevates for the board. Here come the Hawks. Here's Arudia sprinting in. He's cut up to the right baseline. Circles out towards the corner. Skips it down low for Cheeseman. Cheeseman double-teamed right baseline. Starts his dribble and backs down Adji. Kick out for Arudia. Pump fake into the left wing. Now Arudia straight away from downtown. Back iron. Jimpy elevates the offensive rebound. And he's in the middle of the lane. He's fouled in his pursuit of a bucket.
Well, Jimpy is very athletic, and he's long and can jump. It's going to be a great, it's going to be a plus for the Hawks throughout the entire year.
Cintron picks up the foul. It's the first of the game for Blue. Frost gets the inbound. Left elbow. Kicks it out for Andino for three. In and out. It was halfway down, but Arudia chases down the offensive board. And a fresh 30 for the Hawks.
Yeah, wide open look for Andino that time.
3-2 Shore. 17 and change to play before halftime. And that's the rust that Andino's trying to shake off still from that year of injury. He'll try again from three, but before he can, it's an offensive foul, an illegal screen. It'll be Ahmad Frost. First foul, the fourth already for Maryland Eastern Shore. Four fouls in the first 3 minutes, and that's not what you want with a shorthanded bench tonight. Substitutions for Blue. Oh, who's coming in? Flood took a seat. Spencer Franklin's in now, 6'8 senior forward from Fort Worth, Texas. He's on the floor. Walton, Phillips, Cintron, and Smith joining him. That was the only sub. From the Big M, it's Phillips, marked by Frost. Stops his dribble, flicks it to Walton on the left wing. Walton centers up, travels to the right wing, hands off to Phillips again. Now it's Walton into the right corner. Double team kicked it down low, and it's saved inbounds by Cheeseman. Cheeseman with the steal. Here come the Hawks in transition. Arudia weaving his way through traffic. Bumped on the left side of the paint. Floater, back iron, and rebound hauled in by Cintron. Back and forth the teams go without many points to show for it. Longwood basketball on the right wing at Cintron. Dribbles in. He's stripped behind by Andino. Ball's on the floor. Cintron able to save it. Too many white jerseys. Nobody's able to control the basketball, though, as the Lancers work it down low for Spencer Franklin. From the restricted area, left side, he's fouled on the layup attempt.
Foul charge to Hawks number 22, Gabriel Jimfey.
That's Gabriel Jimfey's second foul. So within the first media timeout, Dave, we got two Hawks with two fouls already.
Two starting with two fouls. Five for the first 4 minutes of the basketball game. That's going to be too many.
Settle in, folks. This could be a long night with impossible odds. At the free throw line, Spencer Franklin. First shot up and rolls out. Tyler Jones checks in. Junior forward from Atlantic City, New Jersey, as Jimfey takes a seat. Tyler Flood's back in. Sean Flood, rather, is back in for Longwood. Spencer Franklin went to a couple of junior colleges before landing in Farmville, Virginia. Last year, averaged 6 points, 4 rebounds a game. Missed 5 games with a foot injury. Second free throw rattles home. 1 of 2 for Franklin, and it's 3-3. 16 and change to play in the first half. Arudia, Cheeseman, Andino, Jones, and Frost on the floor for White. Isaiah Walton guarding Arudia as he's on the right wing. Skips a pass to Frost straight away. Frost looking for Andino. He's cut off in the left corner. Now it's Jones. Jones laterals back to Frost. Now it's Andino on the left sideline. We've got a whistle away from the basketball.
It's on Franklin.
Longwood foul, charge number 13.
Indeed, Spencer Franklin. That's the second foul against Longwood. Franklin's first, and we got 7 fouls and only 6 points in the first nearly 4 minutes of the ball game.
Well, I will see some zone defense in this game, too, just to keep people out of foul trouble.
Frost the free throw line, takes the inbound. Now he finds Andino on the right wing. He's looking down low for Cheeseman. Franklin all over him like butter on toast. They work it to Arudia on the left wing. Elevate to Cheeseman on the left baseline. Double team, strip, kick back to Arudia with 7 to shoot. Brian trying to recover. He's the free throw line, spins to his left. Out to Cheeseman. Left corner for 3. Skims the rim. Rebound. 2 Lancers went for it. It deflects to Frost. Hawk basketball, hand out to Arudia. Missed the point blank layup. Left side. Nobody can buy a bucket early on. Here come the Lancers. Left baseline, Sean Flood. Franklin, center of the lane, and he's mauled by Cheeseman. He was going for the dunk from the center of the paint. Instead, he'll have two free throws when we come back from this first media timeout. A lot of hustle back and forth, and not many points to show for it. 3-3, 15:38 to play in the first half on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
In the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, success for our student-athletes isn't just measured by wins and losses, points on the scoreboard, or individual stats. It's also measured by their performance in the classroom, in the community, and ultimately graduation. Our student-athletes aren't just playing to win a single game. They're playing to win at life, because games end, but life keeps on going. The MEAC, educating student-athletes for the game of life.
Hawks fans, improving reliability with new technology and upgrades is only part of Delmarva Power's commitment to customers. They're also helping customers save money and energy with tips, tools, and programs that can help everyone reduce monthly bills. Just visit delmarva.com/everyone saves for more. That's delmarva.com/everyone saves. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Back at the Hytche, 15:38 to play in the first half. Eastern Shore 3, Longwood 3. Hawks have already committed 6 fouls, so the Lancers are going to have the bonus for the rest of the first half. The last foul committed by A.J. Cheeseman as he hacked Spencer Franklin, who went up for a dunk attempt. Coming up, and the three officials were looking at the replay monitor during that media timeout. The only reason they would was to determine whether or not it's a flagrant, but there have been no extra whistles or explanations, and everybody's keeping a level head, so it seems like it's a common foul.
Yeah, I don't think anybody was too upset after the foul, except for Cheeseman, who was looked like he had a sore shoulder.
Indeed, Cheeseman's on the bench as we come out of this break. Dante Caldwell checks in for the Hawks. Redshirt junior forwards guard swingman from Santa Ana, California. We're thinking about everybody in California right now, of course, with those dreadful wildfires.
That's a shame.
Spencer Franklin's first free throw, nothing but net. Franklin scored 13 points against Big South Power Radford last year on January 18th. That's his career high. 13 to match his number 13. Second free throw. Good. Nothing but net on both of them. 5-3. Longwood on top, 15 and a half to play in the first half. Hawk basketball, here's Andino from the right channel. Kicks it for Jones, who dribbles to the left wing, handing off to Arudia. No look back to Caldwell. Caldwell to the right side, hand off to Frost. Jones coming out for a screen. Frost takes it to the straightaway, now finds Caldwell on the right wing, dumps it down low for Jones. Jones, the 18-footer right baseline, left it well short, and Walton elevates for the board. Longwood moves right to left with the basketball. Here's Walton on the left wing. Stop and pop, and yes, Isaiah Walton assaults the rim and drops the line. 8-3, Longwood, 5 minutes in. Arudia on the right wing for Maryland Eastern Shore. Now it's Andino left of center. Dino takes a screen from Caldwell. He's met by a double team. Now he finds Jones. No, it's Caldwell left wing for three. That's halfway down and rattles out. Blue rebound. That was Walton who pulled it down. Here's Sean Flood. Hands it off to Walton. Now Okafor, who checked in. It's Gus Okafor who's into the game for the first time. Lorenzo Phillips. Walton on the left wing. Screen set by Franklin. Walton met a double team on the perimeter. Floats it into the right corner for Phillips. With 10 to shoot, it's kicked back out to Walton on the right sideline. Franklin sets a screen. Walton instead spins to his right, trapped in the backcourt. 5 seconds left. Okafor, left corner, Flood for three. Bang! Sean Flood.
They must play in Ireland a little bit.
From Dublin Bay. He's one of them. 11-3, Longwood. 14 and change to play before halftime. And we'll see A.J. Cheeseman come in momentarily. Now he got over the back as Arudia lost control of it.
Yeah.
He got behind the midway marker, and Longwood takes over.
The Hawks going to have to hit some shots in order to stay in this game. The ball's gone halfway down a couple times. It's just not falling.
Camille Chapman checks in for Blue. Chapman from Charlotte, North Carolina. He's a sophomore for Longwood. And Cheeseman checked back in for Eastern Shore. Tyler Jones takes a seat. Longwood basketball, 8-point lead and the momentum. Here's Flood talking to the circle, kicks it to Chapman on the right sideline, back out to Flood, who's playing ping pong with Chapman. Now it's Flood again, sees the left side seam, kicks it down low, left baseline for Franklin. He's blocked from behind by Arudia, and Andino picks it up from the floor. Stout defense down low by the Hawks. They're in transition. Here's Frost from the right wing, out to Arudia, around the horn to Andino. NBA range three, left wing, bang! Ryan Andino bringing the hammer down from long range. His first tray of this game. 11-6. Hawks back within 5. 13:24 to play in the first half. Here's Flood on the left channel for Blue. Flood skips it to the left corner for Walton. Down low to Franklin. Left baseline. His toe is tapping the line. And the Lancers give it away.
That's a gift, too, for the Hawks. Hawks playing a 3-2 zone the last two possessions down the floor.
And that's the sort of defense you have to play when you got foul trouble, right?
That's correct.
Lancers subbing in. Who is that masked man over there? Oh, it's Damarian Getter, 6'8", grad student from Dayton, Ohio. This is his sixth year with the Longwood program. More about him later. Arudia, left sideline for the Hawks. Now it's Andino straight away, marked by Flood. Cheeseman sets the screen to the left side. Dino meets a double team, spins around, hands off to Cheeseman straight away. Cheeseman on the right elbow, drives in. He is checked by Franklin. Spencer Franklin reaching the elbows out, giving him a little bump. Second foul against Franklin and the third against Longwood. Officials tonight, we got Sean Campbell, Joseph Palatz, and Pierre Lorenzo. And apologies to really all of you for mispronouncing your names, I'm sure. Ryan Andino checks out and Tyler Jones in for Eastern Shore. 13 minutes to play before halftime, 11-6 Longwood. Hawk basketball, Frost free throw line, finds Caldwell on the left sideline. Back out to Frost, swings it to Jones. Now Rudy in the right corner, feeds Cheeseman down low. He's guarded by Adji. Back him down, facing a triple team, and he does a soft shoe routine over the sideline as well. Back-to-back giveaways with post players not having baseline recognition.
Right. And the Lancers have played 10 players already will in this game, and they got a deep bench. They could be looking to wear the Hawks down a little bit.
Facing a couple of injuries themselves, but even with the two players out, Griff Aldridge is rolling in 13 deep. Hawks bring a full court press. Here's Sean Flood, who tries to navigate that midway for the Lancers. Skips it up to Getter into the front court. Now it's Walton left wing. Back out to Flood. Flood calling out instructions, pointing for Walton on the left wing. Now he kicks it to him. They thread the needle down low for Getter. Getter stripped by Arudia, and Dino comes up with a steal. Hawks scraping their arms back. Now it's Andino, straight away three, halfway down and out once again, and that's about three so far already, Dave. Arudia nearly tumbles into the scorer's table, and now the Hawks are in transition, three on one. Caldwell stripped on the way up. He is fouled. He's got free throws coming up. There was that near miss by Andino. The Lancers tried to really push it into showtime offense. Arudia was there, deflected, nearly took out all of our equipment and our friends from the Longwood radio booth. Andino was there to clean up, and Eastern Shore got a look down low, and Dante Caldwell's got free throws.
There's a lot of action in that quick 10, 12 seconds.
How's your heart?
I have my hands up ready to catch her.
As Caldwell nails his first free throw, see, we'll be all right. It's the equipment that I worry about.
Yeah, that's true. The equipment's in front of us. It's going to take the hit first.
Tyler Jones checked back in for Ahmad Frost for Eastern Shore. I imagine we're going to see short little spurts from everyone the rest of this first half for the Hawks, with two Hawks already on the bench with two fouls as Caldwell hits both of his free throws. First points of the game for Dante Caldwell. Hawks have scored five in a row now. It's 11-8 Longwood, 12 and change to play in the first half. A trap in the left corner, and the Hawks come up with another steal. Arudia left sideline for Eastern Shore. Arudia circles up back at the free throw line, retreats to the right wing, swings it to Jones. Now it's back to Arudia on the right channel. Arudia moonwalks back, finds Caldwell left of center. Dante marked by Getter. Towards the right channel, hands it off back to Jones. Jones to Andino. Would he try from 40? No. Instead, he'll swing it to Caldwell on the right wing. Caldwell straightening up. Five to shoot. Arudia, contested three from the right wing. Lips out. Walton elevates for the board. Here come the Lancers. Here's Sean Flood. Flood spins to his left. Travails to the left sideline near us. Now he centers back up again. Chest pass to Walton on the right sideline. Back out to Flood. Round the horn to Smith. Thought about the three. Flood. Walton. Walton steps in 18-footer from the right elbow. Yes. Isaiah Walton gave up a pretty tough three look instead to step in and get the two, and he nails it. 13-8 Longwood. 11:08 to play in the first half. Jones right wing for three, and he rolls it in. Tanner Jones found himself wide open by his lonesome on that right wing. Chucked it up and nails. And now we'll have a timeout called by Griff Aldridge and the Lancers. 10:58 to play in the first half. This will become our media. 13-11 Longwood on top on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
If you think you could never afford a health plan, think again. 9 out of 10 people who enrolled through Maryland Health Connection last year got savings. And this year, rates are lower across most plans. They even have experts all across Maryland who can give you free, in-person help to make sure you get the most savings. Learn more at MarylandHealthConnection.gov. That's MarylandHealthConnection.gov. Enrollment runs November 1st to December 15th, so don't wait. Explore your options today.
Imagining a better bank starts with looking at the savings rates most banks offer and saying, really? Capital One is building something better. You can open a Capital One savings account with one of the nation's best savings rates from anywhere, like here,
or here,
or here. One of the nation's best savings rates, opened online, at a Capital One location, or from anywhere. That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
For consumers only, offered by Capital One NA, member FDIC. Copyright 2018 Capital One.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Back in Princess Anne, Longwood 13, Maryland Eastern Shore 11, 10:58 to play in the first half. Longwood Lancers have had quite the rise in men's college basketball. Impressive considering the program is only about 40 years old. The school was founded in 1839 as an all-women's college. Men started informally attending the school after World War II, and they played as the Longwood Pioneers. The basketball program officially started for the men's side in 1976-77. 3 years later, they were in the Final Four in Division III, but that was their last year in Division III. They moved up to Division II in time for 1980-81, and they experienced success at that level, too. Made the Sweet 16 back in 1994, and the D2 tournament back in 1995 and 2001. Became a Division I independent school in 04-05 and have joined the Big South. This is their seventh season in that conference. They've been a doormat historically. Griff Aldridge trying to change that. Lancer basketball, a double team in the backcourt. Phillips falling out of bounds, finds Walton straight away. Walton stripped in the middle of the lane, and now we've got an offensive foul. Insult to injury. Isaiah Walton came tumbling into Brian Arudia, and the Lancers give it away with more than 20 seconds ticked off of the shot clock. On the floor for the Hawks, Arudia, Caldwell, Jones, Andino, and Cheeseman. Remember, Kanan Bartley and Gabriel Jimfey picked up two fouls each in the first 2 minutes. On the floor for the Lancers, I see Walton, Smith, Phillips, Cintron, and Adji, their five starters. Arudia walks it across the big M and into the front court for the Shore. Arudia on the left sideline, guarded by Walton right in front of the Lancer bench. He skips it to Andino on the right channel. Dino looking down low. Instead, he kicks it to the right sideline to Caldwell. Andino straight away. It's a screen from Jones. He'll try the contested three. It's a little bit strong. Rebound tipped out of bounds by Cheeseman, and the Lancers take back over. Ryan Andino, one of four shooting the deep ball so far today. Ahmad Frost checks in. Brian Arudia out for Cliff Reed.
And the Hawks are 3-for-10 for the game so far.
They're certainly trying their threes. They've abandoned the down low, which is surprising considering A.J. Cheeseman led them in scoring the first two games of the year. Lancer basketball. Here's Walton right sideline. Threads it to Phillips straight away. Guarded by Caldwell. Now it's back to Walton. Kick down low. Right elbow for Cintron. He slings it to Smith in the right corner for three. That rattles out. Rebounds on the floor. Scooped up by Jones. Hawks in transition. Caldwell right wing. Slithers in. Up and under layup. Missed it off the backboard. Jones came down with a rebound, but now he got a whistle going the other direction. That's Tyler Jones. That's number one on him. Turns out that was just the sixth foul on the Hawks, and that's the first foul that Eastern Shore has picked up since that opening flourish in the first media timeout. Brian Arudia is back in, and Ryan Andino is out.
Yeah.
So you're going to see Cliff Reed making substitutions
with
the same frequency as you see hockey players. Of course, unlike North Carolina State, where they brought the hockey approach and subbed in five at a time, it'll be just one at a time for the Hawks in the first half. Lancer ball, Walton on the right wing, threads it for Adji on the left baseline. Now it's Walton, spins to his left, working into the baseline. He's triple-teamed. Somebody's got to be open. The pass deflects off the net. They work it into the left corner for Walton, and it's off his hands and out of bounds. They tried to go all the way around the world, and that ball was just too hot coming back to Walton. Broke up in the atmosphere.
Hawks caught a break that time with a bad pass.
13-11 Longwood. It's been that way since we came back from the media. Hawk basketball. Arudia on the right wing, staring down Phillips in his face. He finds Frost left elbow, kicks it out for Caldwell. Left wing three, short, elevating Phillips for the rebound. Phillips in transition, sprinting for the Lancers. Left elbow, he slams on the brinks, fires back for Walton, who elevates from three and buries. Isaiah Walton rising up and nailing another one from downtown. 16-11, Longwood, 8:52 to play before halftime. Here's Arudia, right sideline for the Shore, running the point. Cheeseman comes out to set a screen, instead of Arudia to the right baseline. Back out to Cheeseman. Now it's Arudia again, right wing at the elbow. Finds Jones left the center for three. Shanked it to the right, and Walton climbs the ladder for the rebound. Well, the Hawks firing from long range with great frequency as Longwood takes it down low. That was Smith who tried to find the space on the right side of the paint. Instead, he commits a charge. Hawks standing pat on defense, or standing tall on defense down low. Jayshon Smith with his first foul, and that's a sixth foul against Longwood. Substitution for Longwood, we see Damarian Getter come back in. Getter, it's in his sixth year for the Lancers. His fifth as a team captain. He's had back-to-back season-ending surgeries last two seasons, so this is his medical redshirt and sixth year with the Lancers. Actually, last year was his first year back from those two back-to-back injuries, and he had a breakout season. Puck basketball, here is Frost in the left baseline, finger rolls up and in. Ahmad Frost attacking on the left baseline. Hawks make it one possession again, 16-13. Eastern Shore down, coming up on the under-8 timeout. Down low for Getter, into the left corner. Now Phillips pumps it to Walton. Walton right wing for three. Bang! Isaiah Walton. Only shot 29% from three in the first two games. He's nailed his fair share so far in this one. 19-13 Lancers, 7:45 to play before halftime. Jones takes a handoff as he circles to the left baseline. Turnaround 10-foot jumper, skims the rim strong, and Walton hauls in the board. Here come the Lancers. Phillips weaving his way through traffic. Now it's Walton on the left wing. Threads the needle between two defenders. Kicks out a pass to Cintron. Nearly traveled. Smith, left corner for Phillips. Cross-court rainbow to Walton. Right wing marked by Arudia. Rise right baseline. That valve sealed off. Ball knocked out of bounds. Arudia got a finger on it. Longwood will have it with 11 to shoot when we come back. 7:21 to play in half number one. Longwood 19, Eastern Shore 13 on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
The Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland Salisbury South, is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you is a clean, comfortable hotel room with complimentary Wi-Fi. Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland Salisbury South, is only 7 miles from the Maryland Eastern Shore campus. Also within walking distance of five local restaurants and features a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to campus. Hampton Inns and Suites, an official supporter of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics. Hey Hawks fans, season tickets are on sale now. Visit umestickets.com to get your basketball season tickets. Stop by the athletic office, go online, or check your mailbox. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore tickets. There's no better place to be this basketball season than the Hytche, cheering your Hawks on towards a conference championship. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore basketball season tickets now at umestickets.com. Support Eastern Shore Athletics, because after all, this is our shore and our team.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Back at the Hytche, 19-13, Longwood leading the Hawks 7:21 to play in the first half. Will DeBoer and Dave Bird coming to you live courtside. And, Dave, we touched on this during the break. Both sides struggling, and that's putting it nicely.
Yeah, that is putting it nicely. Both teams struggling from the floor. It was a little bit sloppy. Both teams started out playing man-to-man defense. Hawks got in foul trouble. Hawks now playing his own defense. And the Atlanta are still playing some man-to-man.
Eastern Shore has thrown up far more three-point baskets than twos in this first half as Longwood seems to have a size advantage down low, and A.J. Cheeseman has been held off the board through the first three sequences of this first half. Longwood maintains possession. Lorenzo Phillips will inbound from in front of the Hawk bench, more towards the corner. 11 to shoot for Blue. Phillips pounds the rock, looking down low, and a wide-open getter drives right baseline. Now kicks it to Chapman in the left corner. Cintron fakes a shot at the free throw line, dribbles off of, it looked like his own foot, but it went off of somebody's foot.
I think it went off of Tyler Jones's, I believe.
And the Lancers have five to shoot, and Griff Aldridge is calling for a reset of the shot clock. I think that's what happens when you kick it.
Mm-hmm. I would think so. Back to 20.
Instead, Longwood with just five to shoot as they inbound to Walton straight away. Walton tries to cross up LaFrost. Spin to his left from the left elbow. He misses the shot short. Rebound for Cheeseman, and here comes Eastern Shore. Frost in transition, slows down, scoops it back for Arudia. Arudia looking, head off to Cheeseman, back to Arudia, and now Frost on the left channel, and Arudia straight away for Eastern Shore. Under seven to play before half. A.J. Cheeseman, who's only gotten off one shot so far today. Back to Arudia. Now it's Cheeseman trying the right baseline. He'll try the rock, and they drive in strong, and it's too strong on the shot. Rebound for Phillips. Here comes Longwood. Phillips in the left wing. Back to Walton, and Walton's wide open straight away. Lips out. Jones hauls in the board. Juggled it to himself. Eastern Shore getting a break that time. Walton missed a wide open three, and now a head bob as Arudia sprinting into the front court. He's checked on the way to the rim. Isaiah Walton picks up his second foul, and that could be crucial for Maryland Eastern Shore. Best player for Longwood's got two fouls now.
Right. And that's their go-to guy. They come down and look for it and pass the ball around several times.
That's the seventh foul against Longwood in this first half. So 1-1 coming up for Brian Arudia as A.J. Cheeseman checked out, and Dante Caldwell's coming back in. We'll also see Sean Flood check in for Longwood as Walton takes a seat with those two fouls. Might be the moment for the Hawks. Presume we won't see Walton until the second half with those two fouls. Could be a chance to get back into the game. Brian Arudia from out in the West Texas town of El Paso, and he'll be our halftime interview today. First free throw up and good. Arudia scored 13 points in the opener against Georgetown last Tuesday. Also had 5 assists and 5 steals and 5 rebounds. It was 5.5 assists per game, third at this juncture in the MEAC. Second free throw rattles around and in. So Brian Arudia makes both of his free throws. His first points to the contest, and Eastern Shore's back within 4. 19-15, Longwood, 6:25 to play before halftime. Lancer basketball, Cintron floats it over the front court. Flood deflects it, and it's intercepted by Arudia. 2-on-1, Arudia scoops it back for Jones. TJ, right side layup is in. Eastern Shore on the fast break. Tyler Jones on the feed from Arudia. 19-17, Lancers, 6:06 to play in the first half. Eastern Shore trying to get the crowd into this one. They've filed in, and they are here at the Hytche. Khalil Chapman, top of the circle. Now it's Cintron for Longwood. Hands it off for Phillips straight away. Back to Cintron, right baseline. 9 to shoot, and he got great separation underneath the basket. A reverse layup right to left. Cintron with an easy bucket, 21-17, Longwood. It's Nate Silver time, 5:38 to play in the first half. Frost left sideline for the Hawks. Here's Jones, right wing three. Well off the mark to the left, and Phillips corrals the rebound. Longwood spinning into the front court. Phillips nearly lost it. Gets it back. Floats it to Chapman in the right corner. Now it's back out for Cintron. And it's Phillips straightening up to Cintron, left wing. Thought about finding Flood in the left corner and say he'll take it himself. Now he can set the Flood on the left wing. Floating it into the right corner for Chapman. Chapman back up for Flood. Fakes the three-pointer from the right wing. Dribble drive in. Float shot from the middle of the lane. Well short. Caldwell there for the board.
The Hulk caught a break there. A wide open shot from about 3 feet.
Longwood had three or four of those on that possession. They tried too hard for the absolute perfect shot. Hawk basketball, under five to play in the first half. Here's Dandino straight away. Dandino, that's the signature move for him. 1 point basketball game. Longwood 21, Shore 20, 4:40 to play in the first half. Here's Sean Flood and the Lancers trying to hold off this Hawk run. Flood circling around to the right corner. Now it's Cintron on the left channel. Cintron spin. Back out to Phillips. Phillips trying to cross up Frost. Arudia comes over to help. Double team. Sideline. Cintron in the left corner with eight to shoot. Cintron finds Flood straight away. He'll try the NBA range three, and he got it. Sean Flood with another tray.
That was a deep tray.
Deep tray and a much-needed bucket for Longwood to quell some of that momentum. 24-20 Longwood. We're coming up on the last media timeout of the first half, and three subs are due on for Longwood. Here's Arudia, left channel for the Shore. Stops his dribble. Skips it back for Andino at the maroon M. 10 to shoot. Andino jump pass for Jones. Too tall for him. Ball deflected and hauled in by Cintron for a steal. Here come the Lancers. Here's Flood on the left wing. Andino in his face. Flood dribble driving left to right across the paint. Kicks it out for Cintron. Thought about the three-point shot. Instead, he'll throw it behind the shoulder layup from the left side, and he's fouled. Cintron accelerating in. Dante Caldwell picks up the foul, and that's our last timeout of the half. 3:42 to play in the opening session. 24-20 Longwood Lancers lead on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Hawks fans, improving reliability with new technology and upgrades is only part of Delmarva Power's commitment to customers. They're also helping customers save money and energy with tips, tools, and programs that can help everyone reduce monthly bills. Just visit delmarva.com/everyone saves for more. That's delmarva.com/everyone saves. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics. The Eastern Shore is a perfect place to visit year-round. A gem hidden on the lower shore is the Henson. Located in the heart of Princess Anne on the picturesque campus of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, the Henson is the perfect choice for campus visits, business trips, reunions, meetings, and relaxing getaways. Check into the Henson and we'll take care of the rest. Book online at umes.edu/Henson.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
We're back at Princess Anne. Maryland Eastern Shore trailing Longwood 24-20. We've got 3:42 to play in the first half. Coming up at halftime, statistical breakdown analysis, and we'll have an interview with Brian Arudia, the new point guard and floor general for the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks. Arudia has had a couple of nice assists and some great efforts on both ends of the court.
He runs the floor extremely well, takes care of the basketball, and he's looking to dish it. I give him credit for that. But then the Hawks are hitting some shots now, and that's going to help him and the Hawks on the scoreboard.
Longwood basketball and some free throws coming up for Jordan Cintron.
On the line, 1-1 for the Lancers, number 20, Jordan Cintron.
Cintron from the Bronx. Finished up his pre-college career at Bull City Prep in North Carolina. Sophomore's first free throw up and good. Cintron being in New York City, they've undergone their own share of natural disasters over the years, and Jordan volunteered for the relief effort for Hurricane Sandy. I believe that was back in 2012. Also plays guitar and piano. Well-rounded young gentleman. Second free throw rattles home, and he makes both of his shots. As substitution, Longwood sending Gus Okafor back into the game. Hawk ball down 6-3, 40 to play before the half. Here's Tyler Jones, right sideline. Cross-court rainbow to Cheeseman. Hands off to Arudia. Caldwell and Frost also on the floor for White. Arudia dribbles to the left sideline. Now he finds Frost straight away with Phillips in his face. Screen set by Cheeseman. Frost gets separation, fires up a three, leaves it on the front of the iron, and Adjie hauls in the rebound. Pernell Adjie back into the game. John Flood stutter stepping over the timeline. Flood to the right elbow. Trapped in the corner, now dribbles out again, calling for Okafor for a screen. Okafor gives it to him. Flood straight away, pick and roll to Okafor. Kicks it to Smith in the left corner. Smith centering up, stops at the free throw line. Laterals back to Frost with nine to shoot, or a Flood rather. Flood, right side of the paint, back out to Okafor for three on the right wing. Well, strong. Caldwell takes in the rebound and hauls it in. Okafor was closing fast on that board attempt. Here's Frost right at center for three. Missed everything off the backboard on the right side. And Longwood takes over again. Longwood basketball. Here's Okafor on the scoop pass straight away for three. Ooh. And he missed everything as well. Oh. Well, that basically sums up this entire first half, doesn't it?
What's going on? Back-to-back air balls.
Heck,
really?
We could have done that. Two of us could have done that.
Both teams.
Hawk basketball, and Dante Caldwell's calling a timeout. Eastern Shore will stop action, try and regroup here as Ace Custis, assistant coach, has a look on his face like he just had a whiff of stinky cheese. And we just softened those two shots, the best equivalent of stinky cheese. 2:22 to play in the first half. We're sticking with you. Longwood 26, Eastern Shore 20. Longwood, under the direction of Griff Aldridge. He's their new head coach. Spent two seasons as the chief of staff and assistant coach for Ryan Odom at UMBC. Last year, the historic season, the America East Championship, and the upset. The 20-point win as a 16 seed over number one Virginia. A win that brought in an estimated $120 million worth of advertising, equivalent to that school in Baltimore County. And certainly, yeah. I'll remember where I was when UMBC Virginia, I'm sure you will as well.
Oh, yes.
And we're going to forever remember the name UMBC and everyone who was involved with it, Griff Aldridge included, a new boss at Longwood. Hawks inbound. Here's Arudia on the right sideline. Rudy, the hand in his face, trying to get some separation. Right baseline. Skips it down low for Cheeseman. Cheeseman, two-handed layup is in. Thought about the dunk. Had to adjust with Smith coming at it with an arm. But A.J. Cheeseman's got his first bucket from the paint. 26-22, Longwood. 2 minutes to go before halftime. They nearly lose it out of bounds. Lancers still have possession. Right corner, it's Smith. Laterals back out for Phillips and Walton as they reset the offense from the left channel. Walton dribbling to the left sideline. He's cut off by Arudia. Now nine to shoot. Skips it for Okafor. Step back 19-footer left wing. Well, short front iron. Rebound deflected. Out of bounds. Dante Caldwell went leaping in the stands. Try and save that one. And a nice job. He leaped over the courtside seats. We might have a spy on the indoor and outdoor track and field team for him when the season's over.
I'm glad he was there, not over top of us.
Oh, goodness. Degree of difficulty just a little bit higher on that. Smith to inbound for Longwood. They got a fresh shot clock. Getter on the right elbow. Spins to his left. He's hacked on the way up. And free throws coming up for the Lancers.
Yeah. If you notice, the Lancers had to put Walton back in the game in order to get some kind of offense because they looked a little out of sync when he was on the bench.
Here's Damarian Getter. Again, sixth-year player. His fifth as a captain for Longwood. Last year, after missing two full seasons in a row, had a breakout season as his first free throw is good. 8.5 points, 7.5 rebounds per game. Sean Flood back in for the Lancers and Ryan Andino for the Hawks. Getter, foot surgery cost him 2016-17, shoulder surgery the year before that. Once upon a time, he was a state champion at Dunbar High School in Ohio. He's a freshman and a junior. His team went undefeated his season 28-0. Second free throw, hooked it to the left, rebound for Arudia. 27-22, Longwood, 92 seconds to play before halftime. Frost on the right channel for the Hawks. Cheeseman swings it to Andino. Dino flips it for Arudia. from the Hawk in the Big M. He'll reset the offense. Here's Andino on the right wing. Floats it for Arudia near the corner. Rudy with 10 to shoot. Spins to the right baseline. Now he backs out. Now he accelerates and again. Kicks for Andino. Left to wing for three. Off the iron. Flood chases down the board. Coming up on 1 minute to play before halftime. Flood in transition for the Lancers. Laterals to Getter. His straight away. Three. Lined it up to the right. And Andino wrestles the rebound away from Adji. Little guy taking it from the big man. Arudia. Breakneck in transition. No foul call as he got hacked on the way up from the left baseline. Flood comes down with the rebound.
Those teams don't mind burping it up.
No, they do not.
30 feet.
Give him some Rolaids or something. Antacid. Here's Smith. Hand off the Flood on the right sideline. Adji sets a screen. Frost gets pushed off. And Flood beside himself. He heard the what.
Yeah.
But, yeah, the what was he pushed him out. Frost sort of stiff-armed him. You can't do that in basketball.
Nope.
Offensive foul against Sean Flood. Hawk basketball. 3 second difference shot and game clock. Hawks can hold on essentially for the final shot as Andino bounces it in for Arudia. 27-22, Eastern Shore down, trying to grab some momentum as we head into the break.
It's the longest possession of the half right here.
And Arudia seems content to milk this clock, at least down to 10. Now it's 13 to shoot. Arudia makes his move to the right wing, staring down Flood. Now 9 to shoot. Arudia, 7 to shoot. Screen set by Jones. Rudy straightens up. Pick and roll. Jones, right wing, 3. Yes, sirree. Just like they drew it up. Jones from Arudia. Half court heave coming from Flood. It's up, and it's off the iron. The backside, he nearly hit it. But with that, we've reached the end of the first half, and Eastern Shore starting to come alive. 27-25, Longwood. Hawks within one possession as we head into the break. Tyler Jones hit the three to bring the crowd into it before that final horn. Let's take a break. When we come back, halftime analysis and an interview with Brian Arudia. Your halftime score from the Hytche Center, 27-25, Longwood leading Maryland Eastern Shore on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
In the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, success for our student-athletes isn't just measured by wins and losses, points on the scoreboard, or individual stats. It's also measured by their performance in the classroom, in the community, and ultimately graduation. Our student-athletes aren't just playing to win a single game. They're playing to win at life. Because games end, but life keeps on going. The MEAC, educating student-athletes for the game of life.
The Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland, Salisbury South, is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you is a clean, comfortable hotel room with complimentary Wi-Fi. Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland, Salisbury South, is only 7 miles from the Maryland Eastern Shore campus. Also within walking distance of 5 local restaurants and features a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to campus. Hampton Inns and Suites, an official supporter of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
Training is about more than muscle. It's about inner strength. So I push myself. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. I train with the best. A team that shares my drive and commitment. We collect intelligence, guard our shores against drug smugglers, and keep our waterways safe. Because our nation expects more. Discover a future that exceeds your expectations. Learn more at GoCoastGuard.com.
Hey Hawks fans, season tickets are on sale now. Visit UMESTickets.com to get your basketball season tickets. Stop by the athletic office, go online, or check your mailbox. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore tickets. There's no better place to be this basketball season than the Hytche. Cheering your Hawks on towards the conference championship. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore basketball season tickets now at UMESTickets.com. Support Eastern Shore Athletics, because after all, this is our shore and our team.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFNSports.net. Now, let's go courtside. This is the Halftime Show.
We welcome you inside the Shore Halftime Show, courtside at the Hytche Center in Princess Anne, where the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks trailed the Longwood Lancers 27-25. Will DeBoer and Dave Bird with you on the network. And Dave, sloppy first half for both sides. The Hawks had glimmers of hope and shades of what they can do, and they ended the first half on a positive note, milking basically all of the clock off, and then Brian Arudia finding Tyler Jones on the right wing for three, and that brought the crowd alive before the teams head to their locker rooms.
They're making a pretty, and they've made it a two-point game by playing pretty good defense, really, because at times the Lancers have looked a little bit out of sorts, especially when Walton was on the bench. And the Hawks played great defense. They just come down and finally shot the ball a couple of times. Tyler Jones. The Hawks are 5-for-18 from three-point land.
Yes.
With Jones being 2-for-3 from three. So maybe they'll look for Jones to shoot that three-pointer.
Yeah, well, that's almost a forgotten part of Tyler Jones's game. His freshman year, he could step out and shoot the three every now and then.
Yeah,
Last year, with the lack of size, they needed to go and have him down low more, of course. But he has been able to step out, and he's been hitting threes. Remember the game against UMBC 2 years ago? He had 28 points. A lot of those were from long range. So this is a scene that Griff Aldridge, at least, is familiar with on that Longwood sideline, thinking, hey, somebody guard him. Somebody guard him on the perimeter.
Yeah. He seems to get open out there. He sets that high pick and then rolls to beyond the three-point line, and he's standing there on either wing. And he gets a good pass, and he knocks that shot down.
Indeed he does, and he is the leading scorer for the Hawks in this first half. 8 points off the bench, 3-of-7 shooting, 2-of-3 from downtown in 15 minutes. Other scorer, 6 for Ryan Andino. He is 2-for-6 from 3. 5 points for Ahmad Frost, a deuce each for A.J. Cheeseman, Brian Arudia, and Dante Caldwell. Then Kanan Bartley and Gabriel Jimfey are scoreless. Bartley held to just 2 minutes, and Jimfey 4 minutes, as they both picked up two fouls before the first media timeout, and this on a night when the Hawks only dressed 8 players. So 8 players dressed, 2 of them with instant foul trouble. You can do the math. Eastern Shore played that entire first half essentially with just 6 guys, and they're only down 2 points. Longwood, meanwhile, has relied on Isaiah Walton for 13 of their points, nearly half the points by Walton himself. 13 points, 5 of 8 shooting, 3 of 4 from downtown, 5 rebounds as well, but he picked up his second foul with about 5 minutes to go before halftime, and we didn't see him since that moment. Sean Flood, 6 points off the bench. He's got a couple of trays. 4 for Jordan Cintron, 3 for Spencer Franklin, all from the charity stripe. 1 point for Damarian Getter, and then Pernell Adjie, Jay Sean Smith, Lorenzo Phillips, Camille Chapman, and Gus Okafor, all scoreless. Shooting-wise, Eastern Shore just 8 of 30 from the floor in the first half. That's 27%. Paltry, to say the least. 5 of 18 from downtown. 4 of 4 from the free throw line. Longwood not shooting that much better. 8 of 21 in the first half for 38%. 5 of 13 from deep. 6 of 9 from the free throw line. So both teams have made 8 field goals and 5 three-point shots. It's coming down to the free throws. And Maryland Eastern Shore has put Longwood on the line a little bit more, and that's allowed them to take just a slim lead. Rebounding wise, Longwood with a 20-17 advantage. Eastern Shore on the offensive end holds the key, 3-1. Situation 8, Longwood, 2 of them for Spencer Franklin and Isaiah Walton. Eastern Shore's got 9 infractions, 2 each on Gabriel Jimfey, Kanan Bartley, and Dante Caldwell, who picked up his second foul late in the first half. Assists 7-4 for the Shore, 5 of them alone for Brian Arudia, who is playing like a floor general out there. He's played all 20 minutes of the first half. Don't be surprised if he plays all 40. Turnovers. This is how Eastern Shore has stayed in the game. They've forced 10 Longwood turnovers in the first half while only giving it away 4 times themselves. Remember, this was a Hawk team that led the MEAC last year in fewest giveaways. And this season, Eastern Shore 11 steals per game through their first two. They've forced 10 of those turnovers, 5 of them via the steal to a 1 for Longwood, and then blocks 1-0 for the Hawks. Points in the paint 6-4 Eastern Shore. Points off turnovers 9-2 Hawks. Second chance points 1-0 for Longwood. Fast break points 2-0 for the Hawks. bench points 16-10 for Eastern Shore. That one tie and two lead changes. Hawks held a one-point lead in the first 2 minutes. Longwood has been up by as many as eight. That cut down to two at halftime. 27-25 Lancers in the lead. Let's take a break. When we come back, our conversation with Brian Arudia and second half action on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Let's think about customization presented by Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Liberty Mutual customizes your auto insurance so you only pay for what you need. So why aren't more things in life customizable? Why should I pay the same amount for a compact parking space as I do for a regular space, right? What kind of lot doesn't reward me for selflessly buying a smaller car to provide more parking room for others?
Go to libertymutual.com for a customized quote and you could save.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
Coverage is underwritten by Liberty Mutual Insurance Company and affiliates. Equal housing insurer.
If you think you could never afford a health plan, think again. 9 out of 10 people who enrolled through Maryland Health Connection last year got savings. And this year, rates are lower across most plans. They even have experts all across Maryland who can give you free in-person help to make sure you get the most savings. Learn more at MarylandHealthConnection.gov. That's MarylandHealthConnection.gov. Enrollment runs November 1st to December 15th, so don't wait. Explore your options today.
I really thought I would die of stress long before the cancer, because the diagnosis brought this avalanche of worries. The money, the travel, the burden on the family. One night I called the American Cancer Society and they helped me map out a plan. Got me free rides to chemo and even a free place to stay during treatment. They took away those other fears so I could rest up for the real fight.
Please give at cancer.org.
The flagship station for Maryland Eastern Shore basketball is WTGM Salisbury, Delmarva's Fox Sports 960.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore basketball from SFMSports.net.
Welcome back to the Shore Halftime Show. Brian Arudia is our guest this evening. Point guard, starting point guard for Eastern Shore through the first two games and for the foreseeable future. So, Brian, you're two games into your D1 college career. How you adjusted moving up a level?
Well, I'm excited. Like I've been practicing for this my whole life, so I'm excited to be here. And I'm just trying to learn the game. You know, it's a faster game, it's just stronger guys, and I'm just trying to get used to it. But I mean, I think we're doing a good job. I'm doing a good job to trying to like adapt to this game. So yeah, it's a good experience. I mean, it's a good experience. Yeah.
Coach Reed has repeatedly called you basically an extension of himself on the floor as the point guard. How have you been able to sort of convey his messages and bring his game to life in front of him?
Yeah, well, Coach Reed has given me a lot of extension through myself to like talk to the guys, to control the game. So I'm trying to do my best possible that I can do to like play the way he wants to play, the play exactly just as hard as he wants to. Because I mean, it's the start of the season, we're starting slow, but I mean, we're trying to get used to his way of style. So it's just a matter of time where we're gonna start clicking, and he's gonna be a really good team.
One thing you notice when looking at the stat sheets from the first two games is you're sort of all over the place there. Scoring, rebounding, assists, and steals as well. I mean, that's a two-way player, and I'm sure that's something that you learned to hustle both ends growing up.
Yes, sir. I've always been big in you got to play defense to play offense. I'm not an offensive player or a defensive player. I try to do everything. I try to do whatever I can to help the team win. So if it's play defense, if it's scoring the ball, whatever I got, whatever you got to take, I'm going to be there, and I'm going to do whatever it's best for the team.
What's the biggest thing for you in the coming weeks and months that you'd most like to improve on in your game?
In my game, just communication. I mean, I got to be a better leader. I can improve a lot in that. And just skill set, we got to make some shots. That's what we're struggling in right now. We got to make some shots. We got to run the plays better. But it's going to come through. We're doing a good job in practice. We're working hard. So it's gonna click.
The next game after this one, we're going to your old home state there in Texas to play North Texas. Now, I know El Paso and Denton, they're kind of far away, but at least
least, you know, you're in the outline of the state at least.
Yes, sir. I'm excited. When I heard that we had a game in Texas, I was happy to go back home for a little bit. I mean, it's going to be a great experience. I haven't heard of them. Like, when I was in El Paso, I never heard of them from North Texas, but I'm excited to go in Texas just for a couple of days, and I'm happy to go back home.
Yeah, appreciate the time, Brian, and best of luck out there, and we're glad you're going to get to go home.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
He's Brian Arruda, everybody. We'll be right back with the second half on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
The Eastern Shore is a perfect place to visit year-round. A gem hidden on the lower shore is the Henson. Located in the heart of Princess Anne on the picturesque campus of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, the Henson is the perfect choice for campus visits, business trips, reunions, meetings, and relaxing getaways. Check into the Henson and we'll take care of the rest. Book online at umes.edu/Henson.
Hey Hawks fans, season tickets are on sale now. Visit umestickets.com to get your basketball season tickets. Stop by the athletic office, go online, or check your mailbox. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore tickets. There's no better place to be this basketball season than the Hytche, cheering your Hawks on towards a conference championship. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore basketball season tickets now at umestickets.com. Support Eastern Shore Athletics, because after all, this is our shore and our team.
Training is about more than muscle. It's about inner strength. So I push myself. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. I train with the best. A team that shares my drive and commitment. We collect intelligence, guard our shores against drug smugglers, and keep our waterways safe. Because our nation expects more. Discover a future that exceeds your expectations. Learn more at GoCoastGuard.com.
Hawks fans, improving reliability with new technology and upgrades is only part of Delmarva Power's commitment to customers. They're also helping customers save money and energy with tips, tools, and programs that can help everyone reduce monthly bills. Just visit Delmarva.com/everyone saves for more. That's Delmarva.com/everyone saves. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Second half action coming your way from the Hytche Center. Maryland Eastern Shore trailing Longwood 27-25. A couple other games going on in the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference tonight. Halftime at South Carolina, Norfolk State trailing the Gamecocks 37-23. Halftime at Loyola of Maryland, Dell State is trailing 35-29. Halftime at Bethune-Cookman, the Wildcats cruising against a non-D1 opponent, up 53-14 against Trinity Baptist College. They're going to need a couple of Trinities in order to catch up in that one.
Yeah, you're not good.
Savannah State hosting Tennessee Tech. Tigers on top of 52-40 with 16:20 to play in the second half. Halftime at Cincinnati. NC Central down 34-19 against the Bearcats. Halftime at Howard. Bison 51, Regent University 26. And South Carolina State at Charleston Southern. SCSU down 29-21. 8 minutes to go in the first half. Eastern Shore basketball as we come out of the break. Frost, Arruda, Cheeseman, and then the two early foul committers, Kanan Bartley and Gabriel Jimfey on the floor for the Hawks. For the Lancers, Cintron, Smith, Phillips, Adji, and Walton, their starting five as well. And here we go in the second half. Hawks moving right to left as we see it now. Cheeseman shucks it to Arruda on the right channel. Circles up, flicks it to Frost, right corner, skips down low for Cheeseman. Cheeseman backing down, Angie right baseline, spins to his left, works around with the pivot foot, gets the bump and the bucket. A.J. Cheeseman asserting himself down low. And that's what we expected to see from Cheeseman all night. He goes after Pernell Adji, and he's got a chance for a three-point play.
It's the second bucket of the night, and maybe we're going to go down to him more often.
Why not? A.J. Cheeseman, he makes his free throw, and the Hawks take the lead for the first time since the first 2 minutes. Cheeseman, Collins Hill High School graduate in Snellville, Georgia. Went to the University of New Orleans for his freshman year. Got just a little bit of action for the Southland Champs, then transferred to Gordon State College back in Georgia. Now he's a Hawk. He promises to be a big addition for Cliff Reed this year. His free throw, strong off the iron, rebound tipped once. Jimpy's in pursuit. And it's out of bounds, but it's going back to the Hawks. Longwood had two guys in pursuit of that basketball, and it looks like Smith saved it in, but Smith shuffling his feet over the sideline. Hawks catch a break. Now 20 seconds into the second half of the 27-27 tie. They've got a chance to take the lead. Arudia flings it in for Frost on the left wing for the Shore. Frost centers up, dumps it back for Arudia. Rudy centers up, dribbling towards Cliff Reed on the right sideline. Looks into the corner. He's cut off. Jimpy sets a screen straight away. Now it's Cheeseman. Right wing for three. Back iron. Elevating Bartley. He comes down with a board. Got the springy shoes on Keenan Bartley. A fresh 30 for the Shore.
Way up in air. Great rebound that time. Two hands. Wouldn't let it go.
Between at least two or three blue defenders. Here's Arudia on the left wing. Kicks it to Bartley straight away. Bartley step back, right elbow, 19-footer. Back iron, Cheeseman, offensive rebound. He's blocked from behind on the third chance. And Frost comes up with a fourth chance. Saved in to Arudia on the left elbow. Threads it down low, Cheeseman. Right baseline underneath the basket. He's blocked from behind, but you can count it on a foul. A.J. Cheeseman, he's fired up. The hoop and the harm for the second time in the first minute of the half. That's the second foul against Jordan Cintron. And we'll see Getter and Flood check back in for the Lancers. Hawks hold a two-point lead, and they've got a chance for three with Cheeseman at the line.
It's their second.
The Hawks have got five. He's pumping iron in the paint. A.J. Cheeseman, 62% foul shooter through the first two games. Nails it. Three the old-fashioned way. Cheeseman's got five in the first minute, plus of the second half. 30-27 Hawks.
All five of the Hawks' points and puts them up three.
Bit of a press. Hawks back off as Getter advances it over the midway for the Lancers. Here's Flood from the Maroon M. Locking eyes with Arudia. Flood dumps it off to the left sideline for Walton with his 13 first half points. And we've got a foul as he's trapped on the sideline. Looks like Ahmad Frost gave him a hip check.
A little bit of contact there. Frost put a little body on him. Frost doing a good job against Walton.
Second foul for Frost. First of the half for the Hawks. Inbound coming from Flood. Pounds the rock. Flings it immediately to Walton. He's got Cheeseman in his face. No look dump off to Flood in the backcourt. Now it's Phillips on the right wing. Overhand pass back to Flood. Pump fake left side. Phillips. Flood again left wing. Eight to shoot. Skip down low for Getter. Out to Walton on the right wing. Arudia in his face. Heads bumping. No call. Three to shoot. Phillips straight away. NBA range three. Bang! Lorenzo Phillips on a broken play, and the Lancers catch a break.
The Hawks play great defense, and the Lancers chuck off a 32-footer, and it goes in.
Fortune friendly to Longwood, 30-all, 2 minutes into the second half. Here's Frost in the backcourt for the Hawks. Flicks it to Bartley, skips it down low for Cheeseman, right baseline. Cheeseman backing down his man Franklin. Nine to shoot, spin in the right baseline, out to Frost. He's wide open for three. Got it! Ahmad Frost. They left him alone on the perimeter, and he makes them pay. 33-30. The team's trading haymakers. Eastern Shore on top. 2.5 minutes in to the second session. Flood saunters over the timeline for the Lancers. Left sideline, he finds Phillips right in front of Coach Aldridge. Centers up, does Phillips. Phillips with a desperation three that went down last possession. Flood straight away, circles in, left side of the paint, pump by Arudia. Dump off left corner for Walton. And we've got traveling. Walton skids his tires, and the Hawks take over. Emil Chapman checks back in for Longwood. The Eastern Shore with possession of the basketball. They've got the largest lead of the game. They can push to two possessions with the bucket right here. Here's Frost in the right channel for the Hawks. Now it's Gabriel Jimphy, left wing, cutting in against Getter. Hands it off back to Arudia. The resets on the left wing. But to Cheeseman. Cheeseman dribbling the right sideline. Fakes a handoff. Spins to the left side. And attacks the rim with a grand fury. A.J. Cheeseman sliding to the bucket like a guard. 35-30 Hawks, and Longwood throws it away. Security guard in the corner.
Makes the play.
Yes, he does. Saves it in.
Cheeseman exerting himself to start the second half.
Explosive.
7 points.
7 points before the first media timeout, and he is Mr. Second Half. He got 14 of his 18 points against North Carolina State on Saturday after the break. Same story in Georgetown. Alley-oop down low from Cheeseman. Catches it left side, and he's blocked by Franklin. Spencer Franklin with the hops to deny Cheeseman another easy bucket. 35-30, Hawks still up. Longwood basketball. Here's Getter straight away. They pump it into the right corner for Phillip. No, Chapman. Now it's at the Flood. Flood stops at the top of the circle. Deflected by Frost. Retrieved by Phillips. Phillips on the left wing. Hand off to Franklin. Flicks it back to Phillips with nine to shoot. Phillips. Flood. Right wing. Catch and shoot three. Short. Elevating Bartley, but he has it stripped by Franklin, and Spencer Franklin with an easy left side layup. Great hustle from Spencer Franklin. Dreadlocks flying. 35-32 Hawks under 16 to play in the ball game. We'll have a media timeout at the next whistle. Here's Frost at the top of the circle for the Hawks. Arudia left sideline. Flood right in his face. Screen coming from Cheeseman. Arudia takes it. Pick and roll to Cheeseman on the left wing. Met by Franklin as he tries to end. 10 to shoot. Arudia retreats into the backcourt. Another screen from Cheeseman. Arudia right side of the paint on the baseline, and he is tripped on the way to the basket. I think it's going to be a foul on the floor. But with only 3 seconds left on the shot clock, Eastern Shore have a chance at more points when we come back. 15:30 to play in the second half. Eastern Shore 35, Longwood 32 on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
In the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, success for our student-athletes isn't just measured by wins and losses, points on the scoreboard, or individual stats. It's also measured by their performance in the classroom, in the community, and ultimately graduation. Our student-athletes aren't just playing to win a single game. They're playing to win at life, because games end, but life keeps on going. The MEAC, educating student-athletes for the game of life.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Back at the Hytche, 35-32. Maryland Eastern Shore taking the lead over Longwood, 15:30 to play in the second half. The A.J. Cheeseman Show. It's been a second-half engagement the first three games of the year, and it continues tonight. Cheeseman, 7 points in that first spurt of the second half. He had just three shots in the first half as Longwood largely held him in check. Not so much now. Muscling down his men, and even slithering in like a guard.
Yes, moved all the way from the baseline. Still spin moves and good to go.
Five shots in the second half already. Cheeseman for the game, 9 points and four rebounds. Hawk basketball, 20-second shot clock as that foul against Arudia was on the floor. Into Andino, right corner catch and shoot three, lips out. Tyler Jones tips it out of bounds, but no, it's off of Blue. It's like Getter got a fingertip on it. Jones, Andino, and Caldwell all into the game for Maryland Eastern Shore as Cliff Reed hasn't had to worry about fouls so far in this initial bit of the second half.
It's a good thing.
That was the third foul, though, against Spencer Franklin for Longwood. Arudia at the free throw line loses the handle, and it's out of bounds going Longwood's way. Arudia tried to do too much too fast.
Both teams kind of get a little bit, might get a lead, and then they have a tendency to throw the ball away or just give the other team the opportunity. Hawks with a little full-court pressure now.
Sean Flood staring down Arudia. Matching him left Ginger as he crosses the timeline. Here's Walton on the left sideline. Isaiah Walton trying for the left baseline, and he is fouled before he even really makes his move. Gabriel Jimfey sticking out his hand. That's the third foul against Jimfey. Clock resets to 20 for Longwood. Again, that's the rule in college basketball this year after a foul. Camille Chapman to fling it in. Looking, he finds Walton. Walton looking for his first second half points. Stops from the right elbow and kicks it out to the left corner. That three ball in for Camille Chapman. We're tied. Chapman with his first three, 35-35. 5 minutes into the second half. Here's Jimfey, top of the circle for the Hawks. Hands off to Arudia. Arudia left of center. Leaves it out for Jones, who fakes a handoff to Caldwell. They nearly bump into each other. Caldwell, right channel. Overhead pass to Jimfey. Hand off to Arudia. Loses the handle again. Gets it back. Jumps it past to Caldwell. Right corner. Contested three. Well short. Walton climbs the ladder for the rebound. And Walton zigzags into the front court for Longwood. Fakes a pass to Flood. Arudia would have had a steal if he did let it go. Here's Sean Flood, floor general today. Walton trapped on the right sideline. He's forced to call a timeout. Arudia and Jimfey sandwiching Isaiah Walton, forcing Longwood to burn a stoppage, and that'll take us into another media timeout. 14-16 to play in the second half. 35 all on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Ever wonder why Europeans seem to speak so many languages? Maybe it's because they use Babbel, the number one selling language learning app in Europe. Babbel's award-winning technology gets you speaking right away, whether you're learning Spanish, French, or German. And best of all, you'll remember what you've learned.
I always thought I was bad at languages, but after using Babbel, I can tell you I was just taught the wrong way.
Using Babbel's 10 to 15 minute lessons, you can be speaking confidently in your new language within weeks.
I was amazed that I could start having real-life conversations right away. It was so fast. Now I'm speaking Spanish. Woohoo!
No wonder Babbel is the number one selling language learning app in Europe. Try it for yourself and see why Babbel is the quick way to get conversational in a new language, like Spanish, French, or more. You can try Babbel for free. Go to Babbel.com or download the app and try it for free. That's Babbel, B-A-B-B-E-L.com, or download the app to try it for free. That's Babbel.com.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Back at the now apparently flooded Hytche Center, they're starting the wave.
Yeah.
No comment.
Yeah.
Hawks 35, Lancers 35, 14-16 to play in the second half. And Eastern Shore, you mentioned during that break, Dave, is bringing a double team whenever Isaiah Walton touches the basketball. And he has been the sledgehammer for Longwood tonight. Put a handle on him, you maybe have it solved.
He's got 13 points total. The nearest man to him is six, and a few people, it seems when he's out of the game, they're looking a little out of sync on offense. And so our coach has got them doubling him every time he touches the basket.
Longwood called the timeout after that double team against Walton. So 14 to shoot for the Lancers as Flood pumps it in. Right elbow for Getter. It's back out to the left wing. Now Walton from the big M with eight to shoot. Caldwell guarding him. Screen set by Getter. Walton to the left side. Threads it for Chapman. Chapman to Flood. Catch and shoot right wing three. Bang! With the clock expiring. Sean Flood rises with the moon.
That's his second three.
Third, in fact.
Third,
the Irishman's got 9 points. 38-35. Longwood back on top. 13:47 to play in the second half. Here's Ahmad Frost straight away for the Hawks, dribbling to the right sideline. Frost looking for the open man. Finds Menandino. The desperation three. Pushed it to the right. Jones there for the offensive rebound. Bangs it off the backboard and iron, but he's got free throws coming up. And Dino from long range. I don't think Cliff Reed exactly liked that shot selection from him. Eastern Shore catches the break as TJ was in the right place at the right time.
That was pretty deep.
Yeah, it was. Caldwell out and Brian Arudia back in for Eastern Shore. The foul was on the floor against Jones, so they put it into Frost. into Cheeseman, down low. Cheeseman falling away left side, and he bangs it off the backboard and in.
Good pass by Frost.
Using that backboard like a dartboard. A.J. Cheeseman in double figures to 11 points. 38-37 Longwood, 13 and change of play in the ballgame. This is Cintron straight away for Longwood. Tries left side of the paint, kicks into the corner for Chapman. His three ball skims the iron. Rebound tipped once, controlled by Getter. Fresh 30 for Blue. Into Cintron, who's double teamed. Blocking foul down low against Cheeseman. Cintron went up for the wild shot, then ended up going over the back, but AJ picks up his second infraction, and Cintron's got two free throws coming up.
It seems like both teams go on a little bit of a mini run and get a few points and try to get a lead, and then the lead evaporates and comes back, and this game looks like it's going to be close down the wire.
Like a battle in the trenches, in the sense that nobody can get anything going because they're stuck in slippery trenches.
It's muddy.
It's muddy and it's sweaty. We got an official sweat break here at the Hytche Center. A Cintron to shoot a pair. Cintron went to DeWitt Clinton High School in the Bronx, had four triple-doubles in his career. Senior year was a captain, led the team in points, rebounds, and steals as he nails his first free throw. Jordan Cintron went to Bull City Prep in North Carolina, the Durham area, as you would expect. Second free throw up and good. 40-37, Eastern Shore down. As Dante Caldwell checks in, Ahmad Frost is out. Jordan Cintron hitting both of his free throws.
Yeah. Coach Reed is rotating his players nicely throughout the course of the half.
Again, only eight players active tonight for Maryland Eastern Shore. A shallow bench for Cliff Reed and crew. Tyler Jones holds it on the left channel, retreats back to Andino. Now it's Caldwell on the right sideline, scoops it off for Arudia to run the offense. 10 to shoot. Jones takes a screen. Longwood comes over to help. Arudia left elbow, kicks to Andino. Left wing three, well short, front of the iron. Rebound scooped up in transition by Phillips. It's 2-on-1. Phillips scoops it out, left corner. Chapman fires from three. Skims the rim. Caldwell there for the easy board. Both teams trading three-point misses. Eastern Shore basketball. Here's Arudia straightaway at the right elbow now. Bounces it out for Andino. Now it's Arudia again. Feeds Cheeseman down low. Feed that beast, Chapman. Now Caldwell's wide open. Now Jones left wing for three. Bang! Cheeseman drawing the double team. Caldwell was open. Jones was more open. TJ, his third tray. He's got 11. 40 all. 12 and change to go.
That's a good offensive play. Tyler Jones for three.
Longwood basketball. Here's Getter left of center. Chest pass to Walton. Deflected by Caldwell. Dante sticking to him like a mousetrap. One of the glue ones. 10 to shoot. Walton double team backcourt. Reaches around and flings the pass to Cintron. They skip down low for Getter. Out to Walton straight away. Caldwell comes over to help. Float shot from the free throw line. Back iron. Caldwell holds in the rebound. Hawks hold on defense. Now they fire a Hail Mary down low for Cheeseman. A.J. Cheeseman left side layup. Countered and the foul.
Cheeseman with a great catch. In the lane with a left hand and put it up nicely. Got pushed from behind.
Caldwell doing his best Manning impression. Pick which one is your favorite. Cheeseman's got a chance for a three-point play when we come back. 11:39 to play in the second half. Eastern Shore 42, Longwood 40 on the Shore Sports Network and sfmsports.net.
The Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland, Salisbury South, is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you is a clean, comfortable hotel room with complimentary Wi-Fi. Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland, Salisbury South, is only 7 miles from the Maryland Eastern Shore campus. Also within walking distance of five local restaurants and features a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to campus. Hampton Inns and Suites, an official supporter of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics. Hey Hawks fans, season tickets are on sale now. Visit umestickets.com to get your basketball season tickets. Stop by the athletic office, go online, or check your mailbox. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore tickets. There's no better place to be this basketball season than the Hytche. Cheering your Hawks on towards a conference championship. Get your Maryland Eastern Shore basketball season tickets now at umestickets.com. Support Eastern Shore Athletics, because after all, this is our shore and our team.
This is Hawks Basketball from sfmsports.net.
We're back at the Hytche, 42-40. Maryland Eastern Shore leading Longwood, 11:39 to play in the second half. Griff Aldridge and the Lancers looking for their first 3-0 start since joining Division I back in 2004-05. They've been a doormat in the Big South for basically the entire time that they've been in that conference. They're not the baby of the league anymore, though, as the Hampton Pirates, formerly of the MEAC, joined the Big South over the offseason. Longwood picked to finish 10th in the Big South. Hampton picked to finish 3rd. But the Lancers, it's a new day for them under Griff Aldridge, who's in his first year as a head coach. Again, the two-year chief of staff for Ryan Odom at UMBC. Before that, one of the more unique paths of anyone to become a head coach in Division I. Yes. He was out of coaching, formally at least, for almost 20 years. He was a partner at a top law degree, law firm, Vinson & Elkins. He also built his own oil and gas company down in Texas. He coached AAU basketball, focusing on the poorer 3rd Ward section of Houston, before deciding, you know what, let's do this coaching thing full-time. I'd say it's worked out for him handsomely. Cheeseman's free throw in and out, and Cintron with the rebound. A.J. Cheeseman can't convert 3 the old-fashioned way. Longwood basketball. This is Phillips who zigzags into the front court. Chucks it up for Chapman. Now it's Phillips and Cintron left sideline. Walton has been kept a lid on him in the second half. Eastern Shores bottled him up. Cintron at the free throw line, thinking about moving to the right against Caldwell. Moves left, spins right, kicks it out right wing. 3, good. Chapman. Camille Chapman. Now the game swings back to blue. Longwood leads 43-42. 11:07 to play.
Chapman shot the last 3 for the 3 threes for the Lancers.
Here's Rudy at the free throw line. Steps in. No look. Pass it right to Isaiah Walton. And he almost looked like he was surprised to get the basketball. It's like, oh, is this mine? Okay.
Right in the chest.
Lancer ball. Straightaway getter. Flicks it to Walton on the left sideline. Caldwell comes over to double team. It's out to Phillips. Now right corner for Chapman. His 3 ball again. Skims the iron. Cheeseman with the board. Tax time. 10:40 to play. 1-point Longwood lead. Here's Arudia right channel for the Hawks. Arudia pacing back and forth, biding his time. Walton right in his face. Arudia backs him down on the perimeter. Jones comes over to help. Dumps it off for Jones, right sideline. 10 to shoot. TJ stops his dribble. Skips it to Cheeseman in the right corner. Cheeseman, what'll he try here? He'll try baseline against Cintron. Spins to his left. Fadeaway 16-footer. In and out. Frost fights for the rebound. Gets it. Bumped down low. Lays it up and in. Ahmad Frost cleans up off the glass.
That's the second time this game he's snuck in there after a rebound and stole it away.
10 minutes to go. 44-43. Eastern Shore on top. Longwood basketball. Here's Lorenzo Phillips. Cintron straight away and Phillips again. Watch for Camille Chapman. He's thrown up a couple of threes from the right side the last 2 possessions. 9 to shoot for Blue. Here's Cintron straight away against Jones. Driving right baseline. Throws up a hook and makes it. And 1. Jordan Cintron with that catapult shot gets the contact with Jones. I think that was all he was going for, but he'll certainly take the bucket.
He's going to take it. He only shot that ball after the whistle off the guard.
That stops a 5-0 Hawk run over the past minute and a half. And Jordan Cintron's got a chance for a 3-point play. Personnel change for the Hawks. Ryan Andino back into the game. It's Andino, Rudia, Cheeseman, Jimphy, and Caldwell on the floor for White. For Longwood, Walton, Spencer Franklin, Cintron, who's at the free throw line, Smith, and Phillips. Cintron. Free throw, nothing but net. 3-point play for Jordan Cintron, 46-44 Longwood, 5:42 to play. Ryan Andino from the Big M for Eastern Shore floats to Cheeseman on the right sideline. Cheeseman hands off for Arudia. Rudy, right channel, straightens up, stares down Phillips. Skips it to Andino on the right sideline. Dino floats it out for Arudia in the corner. Cheeseman sets the screen. Arudia, pick and roll. Cheeseman right baseline. He throws up a powerful shot, but he is picked up for the charge. A.J. Cheeseman tried that right baseline. Blue sealed off the lane. I'm not sure who got in there to seal his feet down. Looked like it might have been Cintron.
A little too aggressive that time. Should have stopped and popped right off the side. Backboard.
Oh, yeah, things he'll learn as his D1 debut, or not debut, but you know, full-time debut, continues. Longwood basketball, we got a whistle away from the Rock, and it's Dante Caldwell who's making a face. Oh, no, it's Gabe Jimphy. That's Jimphy's 4th.
Gabriel Jimfey has his fourth foul with 9:11 to play in the second half. Kanan Bartley checks in. Oh, Dave, if you had told me that after the first 4 minutes of this game, it would take until 9 minutes to go for somebody on Eastern Shore to pick up a fourth foul, I'd say that was a win.
You would have lost that bet, yes, you would have. Because they've done a great job manipulating the bench with just 8 points.
Smith has to let it bounce behind the timeline. It nearly slipped. It did slip through his fingers. He's lucky he didn't touch it for over the back. But Phillips has it into the front court, left sideline, 10 to shoot. Here's Smith straight away, hand off to Walton. Walton double team left sideline, scoops it out for Phillips in the left corner. Cross court rainbow to nobody. Out of bounds into cheerleader alley. And Eastern Shore forces a turnover.
Hawks doing a yeoman's job on Walton. Every time he gets near the ball, he has two guys on him.
Has he even scored in the second half? I don't think he has.
I don't think so.
13 in the first half. And a goose egg since the break. Hawk basketball, Arudia running the show. Kicks it to Bartley on the left wing. Bartley back out to Caldwell, around the horn to Andino. Dribbles once, stops it, retreats back to Caldwell. 10 to shoot, Arudia into the left corner for Bartley. Bartley with 6 to shoot. Bartley stops, looking for Cheeseman down low. Floats it to him left baseline. 2, 1, AJ. He lost track of the time and didn't get it off. AJ Cheeseman, he needed a 31-second clock that time. And Longwood holds the full 30.
Somebody should be telling him. I know it's hard to hear with a crowd, but a teammate should have.
It does get loud in this building, doesn't it?
It does get loud, yeah.
When this crowd is filled up, and they are pretty well full, we got a bunch of different teams, we got the bands, we got the cheerleaders, season ticket holders, Jesse T. Williams is here. It gets loud when all of them are on their feet. Longwood basketball, and they've got a wide open Walton in the right corner for three, and he buries Walton. He got Caldwell to fly over him on a fake. Yep. Speak of the devil, and he shall appear. Isaiah Walton's on the board in the second half. 49-44 Longwood coming up on the under-8 media timeout. Arudia from the right channel for the Shore. Rudy flicks it off for Bartley. Bartley back to Arudia on the right sideline. Caldwell sets a screen. Phillip takes to him. Now it's Andino on the left wing. Fakes a three. 7 to shoot. Back out to Arudia. Right side of the paint. Caldwell right corner. 3. In and out. Walton there for the rebound.
Halfway down that time.
4 or 5 of those for the Hawks so far today. Physics unfriendly. Blue basketball. Here is Walton on the right wing, marked closely by Arudia. Bartley comes over to help. He flings it out for Phillips on the left sideline. Phillips dekes in and out against Caldwell. Retreats it to Cintron with 8 to shoot. Here's Flood top of the circle. Chest pass to Walton on the left channel and deep in the backcourt. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Walton slithers in. Desperation, 20-foot, 2-point basket, and he makes it. Walton, his foot was on the line. Not that that'll matter to him as he throws up a prayer for the second time in this half. Longwood gets it with the clock expiring. Dante Caldwell calls a timeout. A split second after he does, Sean Flood took the basketball away. Well-timed whistle from the officials. Otherwise, we're looking at another turnover. But for now, 7:06 to play in the second half. Maryland Eastern Shore trailing Longwood 51-44 on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Hawks fans, improving reliability with new technology and upgrades is only part of Delmarva Power's commitment to customers. They're also helping customers save money and energy with tips, tools, and programs that can help everyone reduce monthly bills. Just visit delmarva.com/everyone saves for more. That's delmarva.com/everyone saves. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics. The Eastern Shore is a perfect place to visit year-round. A gem hidden on the lower shore is the Henson. Located in the heart of Princess Anne on the picturesque campus of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, the Henson is the perfect choice for campus visits, business trips, reunions, meetings, and relaxing getaways. Check into the Henson and we'll take care of the rest. Book online at umes.edu/Henson.
This is Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball from SFMSports.net.
7:06 to play in the second half. Eastern Shore trailing Longwood 51-44. Will DeBoer and Dave Bird with you on the network. And before we lose the opportunity, let's talk a little bit about Sean Flood, who comes from Dublin, Ireland. You're rare to see anybody playing basketball in Ireland, as you have to think
At most, it's the fifth most popular sport over there. They've got their own national sports of hurling and Gaelic football. They've also got soccer. They've also got rugby. But Sean Flood decided to play basketball, and he was really good. Team captain at the U16, 18, and 20 levels for the Irish national team. Also played in the Temple Oak Basketball Cup and the Super League over in Ireland before coming to Santa Fe College in Florida and eventually ending up here at Longwood. So props to Sean Flood, a pioneer of that sport across the pond.
He does what coach wants him to do. He played the point guard most of this basketball game for the Lancers.
And he's very nearly had a steal on that last timeout that Dante Caldwell called. Eastern Shore basketball as they inbound. 7 minutes to go. Here's Andino on the left wing, marked closely by Isaiah Walton, who's busted out for 5 points in the last minute after the Hawks had bottled him up. Like a soda bottle, you can't contain him for too long, or else he'll pop. Cheeseman double-teamed down low, and it's deflected out of bounds. And the pass heading towards Andino. 10 to shoot for Maryland Eastern Shore. You ever been to Ireland, Dave?
No, sir.
That's a
not that part of the country.
Really beautiful country.
I've
if you can get out there.
I've been to Europe, but I have not been to the England and Ireland area.
Well, if you make it to Dublin, his hometown, I recommend getting to Croke Park. It's their national stadium. You see their national games. Inbound, deflected out of bounds, nearly taken out Raylan Wardlaw, our assistant SID, who's bringing us stats. If you're not well-versed with hurling at home, I would recommend you look it up on YouTube. It's a combination of baseball, soccer, field hockey, and football. Played with big wooden sticks and no pads.
Yeah.
It's the fastest sport on grass, and it is terribly exciting.
I'm going to go watch a little field hockey tomorrow night.
Very nice.
My daughter's team playing in a state, Delaware State, semifinals at UD.
Kind of a big one, isn't it?
Yep.
Eastern Shore inbound, six to shoot. Here's Arudia staring down Flood. Screen set by Cheeseman. Arudia still on the perimeter. Pumps it into the left corner. Caldwell for three. Got it! Dante Caldwell at the gun. 51-47 Longwood. 6:30 to play in this ballgame. Brian Arudia, another helper. That's his first of the second half. He's got six. Six and a half to go. Longwood basketball. This is Phillips, the right channel. Skips for Cintron at the right high post. Working against Cheeseman. Backs him down. Pumps out with 6 foot jumper off the iron. Rebound for Andino. Up the right sideline is Arudia for the Hawks. Arudia loses the handle. Cheeseman there to clean up, but he's stripped by Cintron. Now it's Sean Flood, left to right for Longwood, and he loses the handle. It's off Arudia's knee, and he takes out the scorer's table. He hit that shoulder awfully hard, crashing into the boards. I think it was a hockey game by that sound effect.
It doesn't seem to bother him, but he's going right at it again.
I know he played our last two games at arenas that have doubled as hockey complexes in D.C. and Raleigh, but I think Arudia took a little too kindly to that sport.
She's been getting a little blow for the Hawks.
Indeed he is.
Very short time, I'll bet.
Caldwell, Bartley, Arudia, and Dino and Frost on the floor for Eastern Shore. Longwood basketball after the flurry of turnovers. Flood takes the inbound from behind the midway marker. Now he crosses into the front court. Chest pass to Walton, who's double-teamed on the left sideline. Walton fighting in, and he picks up a foul as Kanan Bartley got a little too friendly.
Kanan Bartley is third, team 7.
Hawks playing with a very small lineup now. Four guards out there and Caldwell.
Reminiscent of last year's team that didn't have that much size. Now we'll see A.J. Cheeseman check in as Kanan Bartley and his three fouls taking a seat.
Yeah, Cheeseman got about a 20-second rest.
Quite literally a breather.
Yeah, love it.
Get two breaths, A.J., and you're back in. Isaiah Walton's at the line as that was the seventh foul against the Hawks. He'll shoot 1-1. First free throw up and good. Isaiah Walton, superstar at Elyria High School in Overland, Ohio. Went to UC Davis in 2014-15 and redshirted. Eventually went to Iowa Western Community College, which is an athletic powerhouse, before settling in here in Longwood. And he has been a star. Last year led the team in scoring. 16 points a game. Second free throw's up and good.
That's his 20th point.
Isaiah Walton, another 20-point effort. He had 23 against Richmond in their win. 53-47. Longwood back up 6. 5:48 to go. Arudia for the Hawks. Flicks it for Andino. Now it's back to Arudia from the Jesse T. Williams signature left channel. Hook pass Randino right of center on the perimeter. Now it's Frost on the right sideline. Back out to Dino. Nine to shoot. Scoops it for Caldwell on the left wing. Trying to cross up Getter. Caldwell out to Frost. Frost fakes a shot. Steps in. 18-footer right baseline. Halfway down and out once again. Yeah. Demarion Getter with the rebound.
I would say that's about the fifth one in this basketball game for the Hawks.
I'd say it needs some WD-40 up there. The rim needs something to help these baskets go down for the Hawks. Longwood basketball. They work the clock down to 10. And they scoop it out for Walton. His NBA range left wing three. A little bit short. Nandino fights for the rebound. They are prepared to explode on the bench if he makes that. Cheeseman with the ball for the Shore. Now it's Andino and Arudia. Under five to play. Arudia slowing things down. Edge of the M. Saunters to the right sideline now. Cheeseman set to screen. Pick and roll. It's Cheeseman right baseline. Step back 19-footer. Yes! A.J. Cheeseman with the mid-range jumper. He's got 15. And Arudia's got his seventh helper. 53-49. Hawks within four. 4:28 to play. Phillips on the right channel for Longwood. Skips to the right high post for Getter. Getter backing down Cheeseman. Kicks it out for Phillips. Now it's Smith on the right wing. Works around the horn to Walton. Walton slithers between two white defenders, and he's intercepted by Frost. Tried that back door. It sealed shut. Frost trying to pump it over the timeline to Andino in the left corner, and he is fouled as he goes up for that football-style pass. Lorenzo Phillips with the foul.
The Hawks play a 3-2 zone down here. The defense given out of the Lancers a little problem.
14 turnovers for Longwood in this game. Just four since halftime, but a well-timed one for Eastern Shore just now. 4:09 to go. Hawk basketball. It's Frost on the right sideline. We're coming up on our final media timeout. Cheeseman sets a screen for Frost straight away. Frost loses the handle, gets it back to Arudia on the left wing. 13 to shoot. Arudia skips it out for Frost. Thought about the contested three. What a guy has swatted in his face. And we got a whistle away from the basketball.
Franklin, I believe.
If it's Franklin, that's four. It's Franklin. And with 8 seconds left on the clock, Eastern Shore will have a 20 when we come back. 3:52 to go in the second half. Longwood 53, Eastern Shore 49. Stick with us on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Stop at your local Eastern Shore McDonald's and enjoy a new 100% fresh beef quarter pounder sandwich. The recipe is simple. Fresh beef, hot and juicy, and made just for you. Try it on a signature crafted sandwich like the Pico Guacamole. Prices and participation may vary. Visit your Eastern Shore McDonald's. If you think you could never afford a health plan, think again. 9 out of 10 people who enrolled through Maryland Health Connection last year got savings. And this year, rates are lower across most plans. They even have experts all across Maryland who can give you free in-person help to make sure you get the most savings. Learn more at MarylandHealthConnection.gov. That's MarylandHealthConnection.gov. Enrollment runs November 1st to December 15th, so don't wait. Explore your options today.
Start your day with the new triple breakfast stacks. Bacon, sausage, egg, and cheese all piled high on your choice of biscuit, McMuffin, or McGriddle. Make it complete with a dollar any size hot coffee for just a buck for a limited time. Prices and participation may vary. Visit your local Eastern Shore McDonald's.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
And down the stretch we come. 3:52 remaining in the second half. 53-49. Longwood leads Maryland Eastern Shore. A back-and-forth second half. The Lancers trying to come in, steal another road win, and improve to 3-0 for the first time in their Division I tenure. It dates back to 04-05. Eastern Shore trying to get off the schneid and win their first game of the season. Hawks are on the road this weekend. They visit North Texas on Saturday afternoon before heading down to Mercer for the Tuesday before Thanksgiving. The Lancers go home and host Delaware State on Friday. Around Thanksgiving, they'll have a tournament at the University of Seattle. Their Big South opener, January 5th, at league favorite Radford.
Are you headed down to North Texas?
Indeed, I am.
North Texas assistant coach named Jareen Dowling. Tell him I said hello.
Oh, absolutely. I've heard good things about Jareen. A.J. Cheeseman at the line for 1-1. That was the seventh foul against the Lancers heading into that timeout. And Cheeseman leaves it strong off the iron. That's been the Achilles heel for him today. Cheeseman 1-4.
Hawks unable to convert. Lancer basketball, 4-point lead, 3:41 to go. Flood running the show for the Lancers. Fakes a pass to the left wing, instead finds Phillips, who flings it back to Flood. Now it's Phillips straight away, and Flood. Left wing, he's left open for three, and he got it. Sean Flood rising up, making a win, shaking the barley, 56-49. Lancers lead, 3:19 to play.
And that is his 4-3 with 12 points for the game.
Frost, right sideline for the Hawks. Scoop in with a layup. That's short. And Jones's tip back a little bit strong. Longwood holds on defense again. This is Phillips, who jogs it over the timeline with Frost in his face. Lorenzo Shabuti Phillips. Now it's Flood on the left sideline. Does he have another dagger in him? Cintron. Hands off to Walton with 10 to shoot. Walton marked by Cheeseman and Arudia on the left wing. A handoff to Phillips. 5 to shoot. Cintron, he'll spot up straight away from 3. Leave it off the front of the iron. And Getter boxes out for the rebound. Fresh 30. That's a dagger for Longwood. And they didn't even make it.
It's a good defense by the Hawks. It's a forced 3. Just got unlucky and didn't get a rebound.
Longwood just looks a little bit bigger. Getter's got an inch and a half over Cheeseman from the looks of it. 10 to shoot. Longwood biding their time. Here's Phillips zigzagging into the right high post. Hands off for Flood. Free throw line cuts in. Flicks it to Cintron. Left corner three. Rattles in and out and back in again. That could be checkmate. 59-49. Longwood nursing its largest lead of the game with 2 to go. The Lancers pulling away and primed to improve to 3-0. Eastern Shore getting to Lloyd Christmas territory. There is a chance, but it's getting to desperation time. Here's Andino, left corner. He'll catch and shoot from three, leave it short. Rebound hauled in by Cintron. And it appears that Eastern Shore has just run out of gas in this one.
A little bit.
Longwood pulling away in the final few minutes. Phillips moonwalks back deep in the backcourt, really close to us. 88 seconds to go on the game clock, 10 on the shot clock. Phillips bobs in and out, retreats it back to Cintron. Now Phillips with 6 to shoot. Phillips charging in against Frost and a push-off. Phillips got too much illicit separation against Ahmad Frost. 1:19 to play in this one. Longwood 59, Shore 49. The Hawks, they need a few threes. They need Ryan Andino. They need Tyler Jones. They need Dante Caldwell to start hitting from deep. Even A.J. Cheeseman, he's got a three this year. Arudia from the left wing. Who will he find? He tries left baseline, circles up, kicks it out to Caldwell. Right wing three. Back iron. Jones chases down the board, but he's called for the foul in pursuit. Cintron hit the deck, and TJ is going to get dinged.
Jones got caught by two referees that time.
Longwood on a 6-0 run. Eastern Shore hasn't scored in their last 3.5 minutes. The foul is the third against Jones, the eighth against the team. Deshaun Smith in, Sean Flood out. Quiet hero he's been tonight for Longwood. Sean Flood, watch out for him. It's a Longwood team. I don't think they're going to be cellar dwellers in the Big South this year.
No, I don't think so.
Cintron to the line. He's had a good game. 12 points. Perfect 5-for-5. Make it 6-for-6 from the charity stripe.
If Coach Aldridge can recruit like he did at UMBC, then you never know what could happen at home.
You never do. They proved that a 16-1 can happen. We knew it would. It was just a matter of when.
When, that's right.
But we didn't think it was going to be 20 points.
No.
Cintron makes
it
both
of his... It was fun to watch.
Yes,
it
yes, it was.
I enjoyed it.
Cintron makes his second free throw. He's a perfect 7-for-7 from the stripe today. 14 points. Griff Aldridge calls a timeout. So the Lancers are 1:02 away from their three-row start in over 15 years. 61-49 leaders. Eastern Shore. They need a Reggie Miller right now.
Yeah.
I don't know if they can find him, but...
13-for-16 from the free throw line too. So that's shooting pretty good there.
13-of-16. The Hawks just 5-of-8.
And Cheeseman's been able to come alive in this second half day, but for the most part, Longwood has held their grip on the paint. And Eastern Shore has not been able to get much of anything going on the inside.
Yeah. The Hawks played a very small lineup several times during the basketball. Due to a short bench, I'm sure. Yeah.
Much better second half for both teams. Eastern Shore shooting 44% since the break. Longwood shooting 56%. And that's where your 12-point lead comes from. Caldwell downloaded Cheeseman left baseline. Now it's Sandino. Left wing three. Leaves it off the right side. Jones offensive rebound. Dribbles down low. He is mauled on the way up. Hitting the deck. Multiple bodies in white jerseys. Jones will have two free throws coming. He nearly landed on Dante Caldwell. Anytime Caldwell hits the deck, you hold your breath.
Yeah,
missed a whole year last season with a knee injury. TJ heading to the line for at least one. I think the officials are talking to see whether this will be on the floor, or they're sending both teams to their respective benches. Would this be a flagrant? Would they even bother at this point? I guess you have to, but it's 47.3 seconds to go and a 12-point Longwood lead. The officials,
they're going to look,
wandering towards the monitor. A foul was against Jordan Cintron, his third. So Tyler Jones will shoot free throws no matter what. It's just a question if it's one or two, and the severity of this foul against Jordan Cintron. If you're looking at game stories, Longwood has shot rather well from three-point range. Coming in, they were just a 28% three-point shooting team. In this game, 12 for 26. Yeah. That's 46%. It's been Walton and it's been Flood. They've each nailed four three-pointers.
That's going to win us the basketball games, 46%.
Eastern Shore, meanwhile, putting them up in high volume, but they're just 8 for 29. That's 28%. And Ryan Andino's struggles continues. He's just 2 for 10. A.J. Cheeseman, another solid second half. 15 points, most of them coming since the break. He's got 5 rebounds. Ryan Arrudia, 0 for 6 from the floor, but he's been helping out with 7 assists, 2 steals, 3 rebounds. Officials are still looking at this foul.
There was contact before the foul. I'm not sure if that's what they're looking at or what.
The three officials huddled together and still discussing things. Sean, Joseph, Pierre. Pierre, what's the call? 47.3 seconds remaining. Longwood 61, Eastern Shore 49. Well, November 13th. It's not even close to February. I don't know what I was thinking. It's November 13th, and for the second time in 2 years on this date, Griff Aldridge is going to come in and pick up a win for the team he's coaching. 2 years ago today, UMBC beat Eastern Shore by single digits. And now this year, Longwood, less than a minute away from pulling off the win over the Hawks again. Griff Aldridge, a standout at Division III Hampden Sydney in his playing career, graduated in 96, went and got a law degree at Virginia, was an assistant coach for 1 year at Hampden Sydney, his alma mater, 1999 and 2000. They went 24-0 in the regular season, one of the best seasons in school history. And Dante Caldwell
taking two
free throws,
two technical
foul shots. And the first one's up and good. Not sure exactly what the call was, but looks like the Hawks will keep possession after this one, and Caldwell hits both of his free throws. Well, 61-51, and he's got two more foul shots coming up. Where does he know? It's Tyler Jones.
This is the foul coming up. Shot the technicals, and now we're shooting. Tyler Jones shooting now where he got fouled.
But he's getting technical foul shots as well as Longwood.
Possession.
Not even there. Jones' first free throw is good. do we have more coming up? Caldwell's hit two free throws in a row, and Tyler Jones just hit one free throw, and they're still discussing things over at the scorer's table. The foul was on Jordan Cintron, and it was enough of the severity to require technical foul shots for Maryland Eastern Shore, and we haven't gotten an explanation exactly as to what it was. We are not exactly lip readers or guys with really big ears. And the arena is not set up to the point that, you know, it's a cylinder and there's a secret spot where you can hear across the court. The additional foul call against Damarian Getter. That's his second, so Longwood's got two fouls against him, and there's total confusion on our part and I think across the way as well. In any case, Maryland Eastern Shore has cut the deficit to 9 points, 47.3 seconds remaining. And we've got more technical free throws coming up.
I think Jones would get another shot.
So Tyler Jones' second technical free throw, he leaves that one strong. He rushed the process there.
Well, they froze him after standing there for 3 minutes.
And now a timeout for Maryland Eastern Shore. Let's take a 30-second break if we can here. 61-52, Longwood on top, 47.3 remaining. This is actually a full timeout, so we can take a full break on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
The Eastern Shore is a perfect place to visit year-round. A gem hidden on the lower shore is the Henson. Located in the heart of Princess Anne on the picturesque campus of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, the Henson is the perfect choice for campus visits, business trips, reunions, meetings, and relaxing getaways. Check into the Henson and we'll take care of the rest. Book online at umes.edu/Henson. Hawks fans, improving reliability with new technology and upgrades is only part of Delmarva Power's commitment to customers. They're also helping customers save money and energy with tips, tools, and programs that can help everyone reduce monthly bills. Just visit delmarva.com/everyone saves for more. That's delmarva.com/everyone saves. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
The flagship station for Maryland Eastern Shore basketball is WTGM Salisbury, Delmarva's Fox Sports 960.
Back at the Hytche, 61-52. Maryland Eastern Shore trailing Longwood, 47.3 seconds remaining. Hawks just hit a slew of free throws, three of them out of four, and they maintain possession of the basketball. Nine-point game, a three-pointer could change a lot of things right here. Cheeseman will try that three. Missed it off the back of the iron, but Frost there for the rebound. Ahmad Frost, he'll fire from long range, and there it is! Ahmad Frost, contested three from the right wing, and all of a sudden, it's a two-possession game. 36.9 seconds remaining. The Longwood lead cut to 61-55. Hawks with 6 points on that possession after the pair of technical foul shots.
And full court pressure now by the Hawks, which they've been pretty successful.
They'll bring Sean Flood in and sit Jay Sean Smith. And Eastern Shore will bring in their defensive team as well. Jim Fee and Bartley checking back in for the Hawks to go along with Frost, Caldwell, and Arudia. Hawks need a quick steal. They'll bring the full court press. Flood inbounds to Walton. Walton with Jim Fee in his face. Coming over to help is Frost. Walton. He traveled. Isaiah Walton drags his foot. The press works. And now the offensive team comes up for the Hawks. Jones, Andino, and Cheeseman. 30.7 seconds to go. 61-55. A three makes it a one-possession game.
I don't know if Walton's a guy to have the ball at that point in time, but it's just by going from his last game where he had double-digit turnovers.
And now Cliff Reed will call a timeout as Maryland Eastern Shore, who when this final minute began were down 12, have cut that deficit in half, and they hold the basketball. Well, can you imagine how loud this place will get if if what you and I are thinking might happen here actually happens?
Well, they drop a three, it's going to be a one-possession game.
Indeed it is. Hawks 9 of 30 from 3. Ahmad Frost 3 of 6. Tyler Jones 3 of 4. You got to be looking at them. Ryan Andino's 2 for 10. It's been three tough games for him, but you've got to think at some point.
He's going to fall.
Yes. So you've got your three-point shooting team in for Maryland Eastern Shore. You think it's early enough that if they get a quick two, they can work with that as well? Quick two and a steal or a foul?
No, yes. You have plenty of time. 30 seconds is eternity in basketball.
Arudia to inbound from the near sideline. Into Andino from the M. Andino sprints to the left wing, right wing. His three ball's good. Ryan Andino from NBA range. 61-58. Longwood's lead down to three. Walton facing a full court press. Longwood trying to get over the timeline. Slithering up is Phillips, and he's fouled in the backcourt by Andino. That's a 1-1 coming up for Longwood. Ryan Andino.
Yeah. Finally, we just got through talking about it. They're going to call. That was deep.
1-1 coming up for Longwood.
Number three,
Lorenzo Phillips to shoot. Gabriel Jimfey in, Tyler Jones out. Longwood's lead was 61-49, 1:10 to play, with 45 seconds to play. The Hawks on a 9-0 run, and they're getting loud as Phillips steps to the line. Good. Two-possession game and a little more breathing space for the Lancers. 22.9 seconds remaining, 62-58 Longwood.
Yeah, still plenty of time to take the ball to the basket right after this free throw. But he got to rebound it.
Jones to come in as well. Phillips, second free throw. Got it. Nothing but net. Shabuti Phillips takes the five-point lead for the Lancers. Jones in, Jimfey out. 23 seconds to go. 5-point deficit. A three cuts it to two. A two cuts it to three. Hawks need a basket of any kind. Arudia sprinting right to left over the M. Arudia down low for Cheeseman. Left side layup. Uncontested. It's good. 63-60. And the Hawks try for the steal. Phillips lost the handle, but Frost came in and sort of slapped him on the arm. Phillips going back to the line, and he'll shoot two as the Hawks are in the double bonus.
Yeah, obviously, this is the guy that the Lancers want to buy the ball.
That was against Mott Frost. That's his third. Only Gabriel Jimfey's got four fouls for the Hawks, and nobody's really got to worry about fouling out of this one.
And we've done a yeoman's job keeping players in the game with only eight players on the floor and nobody.
Eight players, two of them in foul trouble within the first sequence of the entire game. Phillips, who just hit two free throws for the crowd in his ears moments ago, hits a third in a row. He rolls it in. Two-possession game again, 14.7 seconds remaining. Lorenzo Phillips. Second free throw good. He's 4-for-4 in this final minute. 65-60 Longwood. Arudia will let the inbound roll, pick it up near the timeline. 10 seconds left. Andino, NBA range straightaway three, and he's fouled. Oh, that's a late whistle, don't you think? Isaiah Walton, he's got his hands on his hip as if he's thinking the very same thing. But Ryan Andino fouled, shooting a three from about 28 foot away. He missed everything, but Andino's got a chance for three free throws.
And that was the deepest three of the game.
Yes, it was. Third foul against Walton, and we're going to go back to the monitor again. So what's this about? There's no question it was a three-point shot. He was closer to us than he was to the basket.
You're right. He was closer to half court than he was to the basket.
The foul's a third against Walton. 65-60, Longwood leads, 8.1 seconds remaining. If Andino makes all three, and then Longwood will certainly face a full-court press. Anything can happen.
It can happen. All Andino has to make is two to get us to a OT.
Indeed. Hawks coming out from their huddle. With that last assist, Brian Arudia has now got 10. only 2 points, but he has been the facilitator for the Hawks so far today with those 10 helpers. Averaged 8 points, eight assists last year in junior college. And okay, this is what it was about. It was about the clock reset. They had about a second and a half to the clock. Ryan Anino's got three free throws coming. And they pull the blue huddle and get those five players out onto the court. Ryan Anino. His last full season was in the 8% range, shooting free throws, as you would expect. Crowd needs to quiet down here, and they do. Andino's first free throw in, rattles in. It got quiet here awfully fast, didn't it? Pin drop.
Here, knock him down.
Here, pretend you're at the Masters. Second one for Andino. In. Jim Fee and Bartley in, Cheeseman and Jones out. One possession game again, 3 points. Andino, a third free throw coming up. The crowd quiets down as the ball's in Andino's hands. Third free throw, good. Andino makes all three. 65-63, Longwood, 9.6 seconds to go. It's full court press time. Flood to inbound. It's in, and an immediate foul on Phillips. Bartley only lets half a second go off. And now the pressure turns to Phillips. If he only makes one, it's still a one-possession game. He does have two coming up, but Lorenzo Phillips has made four straight free throws in this final minute. If Longwood wins this game, they'll do it at the foul line. They're 17 of 20. And now we've got more stoppages. The officials are going to send them back to the benches, and they're going to take a look at the clock again.
Yeah.
If you're just joining us, well, we've got about 10 minutes worth of a final minute to tell you about, but for good reason. Eastern Shore was down 61-49 with 47 seconds remaining in this game. Longwood picked up two technical foul shots, or intentional fouls, down on the Eastern Shore offensive end. Eastern Shore hit three of those four free throws, and Ahmad Frost hit a three-point basket to make it a six-point possession. Eastern Shore has nibbled and gnawed off as many points as they have been able to since that moment. They've made up 10 points in less than 40 seconds. But Longwood has a chance to ice at the free throw line. 65-63 Lancers, 9.2 seconds remaining, so they add 1/10 of a second, which could make a difference.
Well, Longwood was the one asking about for the time to look at. I would think he would want less time on the clock.
Certainly. Lancer fans at home probably muttering to themselves, tick, clock, tick.
Yeah.
Now what? More stoppages. We'll have some substitutions after this first free throw. Lorenzo Phillips, 4 for 4. And he's 4 for 5. He leaves it off the front of the iron.
Short.
Subs in. Cheeseman, Jones, Arudia, Frost, Andino, all shooters for Maryland Eastern Shore. Longwood cannot make it a two-possession game. Now the question for Phillips, miss it intentionally or make it? And the Hawks get to inbound.
He's going to make it.
Second free throw. Nothing but net. 66-63, 9.2 seconds to go. A three ties it for the Hawks. Arudia over the timeline. Arudia back to Cheeseman. Into the left corner. Jones for three. Front iron. Game over. Tyler Jones with a hand in his face pushed it 2 inches to the right. And Longwood survives. Lancers 66, Eastern Shore 63. You can breathe now, everybody. Close but no cigar for Maryland Eastern Shore. Tyler Jones had a pretty good look. He had a blue hand in his face, certainly. But he nearly made that one.
He had a good look, and he knocked several down in this basketball game.
Indeed, he did. And we're seeing if we can get Cliff Reed over here.
We'll hope.
And he has forgotten once again to come over and Talk to us. All right, no Cliff Reed tonight. Let's take a break. When we come back, post-game show, stats, final thoughts, out-of-town scores, and we'll set you up for Saturday against North Texas. Your final score from the Hytche Center, Longwood Lancers 66, Eastern Shore Hawks 63. Post-game next on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
Hawks fans, for over a century, Delmarva Power has provided safe, reliable energy to customers throughout the region. That's a powerful connection you can count on from here at the shore to throughout Maryland and Delaware. To learn more, visit delmarva.com or call 1-800-375-7117. Delmarva Power, proud sponsor of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Training is about more than muscle. It's about inner strength. So I push myself. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. I train with the best. A team that shares my drive and commitment. We collect intelligence, guard our shores against drug smugglers, and keep our waterways safe. Because our nation expects more. Discover a future that exceeds your expectations. Learn more at GoCoastGuard.com.
The Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland, Salisbury South, is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you is a clean, comfortable hotel room with complimentary Wi-Fi. Hampton Inns and Suites, Fruitland, Salisbury South, is only 7 miles from the Maryland Eastern Shore campus. Also within walking distance of 5 local restaurants and features a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to campus. Hampton Inns and Suites, an official supporter of Maryland Eastern Shore Athletics.
UMES Hawks basketball continues on SFMSports.net. Now, an in-depth recap of the game and a chat with the head coach. This is the All-Access Post-Game Show.
Welcome inside the Shore Post-Game Show. Maryland Eastern Shore falling 66-63 to Longwood tonight. And we were able to snag Cliff Reed, head coach of Maryland Eastern Shore basketball, and he is here with us right now. So, Coach, we shaved the 12-point deficit and made it 2 in the final minute, eventually losing by 3. I mean, it was it got loud in here, and that really got the crowd into it late.
Yeah, I want to commend the young men of Eastern Shore for really fighting and never not worrying about the score, but just playing each possession. And that's what we're trying to do. So that's very gratifying to see those guys play the way we've been teaching.
And Coach, you did a great job substituting people tonight with a short bench, only 8 players, rotating people in and out. And I think the players they got a little tired at the end, but the excitement caused them to go on. But you did a great job rotating players in and out of there.
Well, thank you, but it's easy to do that when you only got 8 of them.
Yeah, that's a thought. That's right.
We just got to get in better shape because we should be prepared to play a 40-minute game. So that's on me to make sure we get in a little bit better shape. I know we were short-handed due to injuries and everything, but I tell you, they'll be commended because we played a well-coached, good basketball team, and hats off to Longwood because they're well-coached, they play really well, and then number one is just a phenomenal score.
Yeah. A.J. Cheeseman led the team in scoring again with 17 points, coming alive again in the second half. Last 20 minutes of the game, he's money. I guess it's just a question now of getting him going in the first 20 minutes, too.
Yeah, absolutely, because I talked to him about that at halftime, that maybe we would have had a substantial lead. And then they would have been playing from coming back, and some of those shots that were the basket big wouldn't have been as big to them if they were losing as opposed to them close game or 1 or 2 point ball game.
Coach, you also looked like you were every time Walton was getting the basketball, you're kind of doubling him, or you're watching him all the time. So I think really they did a pretty good job. He made a Hail Mary in there, running and jumping and making the last. That was a tough shot.
Absolutely. I thought we could have done a better job, and I'm a coach. That's what we're saying. Yeah, I thought he had way too many points. We were running at him every time. We were trying to deny him as well. And like I say, he's a really good scorer. But I just want to improve. I thought we improved from the exhibition to the Georgetown game to the NC State game. Now, we need to get a little bit better and be able to finish and sustain playing well. We had a little lull at the last 7 minutes of the game. And I think fatigue played a part of that because of, like a player due to injuries and whatnot.
Now we got 5 days until North Texas. What's the message as we head down and play the Mean Green?
Let's improve. Let's continue to work at fundamentals. Let's continue to work at transition defense, half-court D, rebounding the basketball. That's what wins games for you, playing defense and rebounding the ball and taking better care of the ball. And we'll make some shots as time go on.
All right. Appreciate it, Coach. And we'll see you down in Texas.
Thank you, guys.
A furious finish to that one. Longwood holding on for a 66-63 win over the Hawks. And Lancers improved to 3-0 on the season. Their first 3-0 start in the Division I era. Eastern Shore falling to 0-3 on the season. And we go straight to the stats. We have a commercial break. I think we're just going to go to we're going to go straight to the stats right here. It's the Hawk Post Game Show, and apparently we're on camera right now, Dave. The live stream for Maryland Eastern Shore is pointing that camera toward us. So let's see if we can turn these chairs around, and let's go for it right now. Final stats. A.J. Cheeseman, as we mentioned, led the team in scoring. 17 points for the Hawks, 8 of 13 shooting, 5 rebounds in 34 minutes of action. And a well-balanced scoring attack for the rest of the Hawks. Again, only 8 players played today. 13 for Ahmad Frost, 5 of 10 shooting, 3 of 6 from deep. 12 each for Ryan Andino and Tyler Jones. Andino had 3 trays and 3 free throws after getting fouled attempting a three-point shot. Tyler Jones, 4 of 9 shooting, he had 3 three-pointers himself to go along with 5 rebounds. 7 points for Dante Caldwell off the bench, 2 points for Ryan Rudia, but Rudia is back with assists, 10 of them, 10 helpers for Rudia, the floor general tonight, and Gabriel Jimfey was scoreless. For Longwood, 20 points for Isaiah Walton, 7 of 12 shooting, 4 of 6 from deep, also had 7 rebounds, turned it over 6 times. Hawks bottled him up really well for most of the second half. He had that one little spurt at about the 8-minute mark, but was relatively quiet after that. 14 points for Jordan Cintron, perfect 7 for 7 from the free throw line. 8 points for Lorenzo Phillips, including 5 of 6 shooting his free throws in the final minute of the game. 6 points for Camille Chapman, 5 for Spencer Franklin, 1 for Demarion Getter, and then Pernell Adji, Jay Sean Smith, and Gus Okafor were scoreless, so we would be remiss. Sean Flood, 12 points, 4 three-pointers in 20 minutes of action for the Irish National. He had himself a really good game.
All at important times, too. This is when they were running the clock right down to 1 or 2 seconds on the clock, and he just knocked them down.
Indeed, he did. Shooting-wise, Eastern Shore, 21 of 58 in the game. That's 36%, but 13 of 28 after halftime. They are 10 of 32 from long range, 11 of 15 from the charity stripe, so they shot their free throws pretty well as well, including all those free throws in the final minute. Longwood, 18 of 39, shooting the rock. That's 46%, 12 of 26 from downtown, 18 of 22 from the free throw line. 82% of your free throws, you're going to win most games.
A lot of games.
Longwood out rebounded the Hawks 34-30, but Eastern Shore owned the offensive glass 11-4. Tyler Jones alone had 3 offensive rebounds. Assists 16-11 for Eastern Shore, 10 alone for Brian Arrudia. Brian Arrudia played the full 40 minutes and 10 assists in this game. Turnovers just 9 for the Hawks, 16 for Longwood. Blocks 1-1, steals 6-3 for the Shore. Points in the paint 18-8 for the Hawks. Points off turnovers 14-10 for the Hawks. Second chance points, Eastern Shore 13-8. Fast break points 4-0 for Eastern Shore. Bench points, the Hawks 31-24.
Five ties, eight lead changes, almost exclusively in the second half.
Almost exclusively in the last 47
indeed.
Seconds.
Indeed. The Lancers and the Hawks battling it out over the final 20 minutes. Eastern Shore ultimately coming up short, 66-63. Tyler Jones had a look from the left corner right over there. As time expired, Longwood got a hand in his face. Jones still able to find iron, but not able to find the twine. And the Lancers held on, 66-63. We got scores from around the MEAC to bring in as we twist around and shout them out. Let's see what we got. A final from South Carolina, Norfolk State, losing 81-64 at the hands of the Gamecocks. A couple of games still going on. This one's just done from Loyola. Delaware State losing to Loyola, Maryland, 91-62. South Carolina State trailing Charleston Southern, 77-66, with 4 minutes to go in the second half. The SCSU is actually keeping up with them pretty well. Other finals, Bethune-Cookman thrashing Trinity Baptist, 104-44. Savannah State holding on to beat Tennessee Tech, 97-83. North Carolina Central falling at Cincinnati, 73-51. And Howard beating Regent University in D.C., 108-51. Well, that'll just about do it for our first home broadcast of the season. Dave Bird, it's been fun. It got really fun at the end. And let's do it again in a couple weeks.
We'll do it.
All righty. Steve Clendenin, our producer back at SFM, we thank him as always. Our next broadcast will be Saturday afternoon or evening from Denton, Texas. That's the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex against the Mean Green of the University of North Texas. That is a 6 o'clock start time. I believe that is 6 o'clock Eastern. They're in the central time zone at Texas. I think it's 5 o'clock local and 6 o'clock back here on the Eastern Seaboard, which means we'll have a pregame show on this network at 5:45. Until then, on behalf of Dave Burton, all of us here at the Hytche Center, this is Will DeBoer saying so long and a very pleasant good evening to you from the Eastern Shore of Maryland. Your final score, once again, the Longwood University Lancers, 66, the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks, 63. This has been Shore Basketball on the Shore Sports Network and SFMSports.net.
This has been a presentation of Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.